Gamers, welcome back. I am Robo. I am a Grandmaster level player at the game of Risk, and today we're not on the Robo account. Today we are Blackberry Bonkers wearing a bucket hat. And we are back today on the Risk meta settings. Also, we are live on both Twitch and YouTube. So, hey man, feel free to stop by the live streams. We're streaming every single Saturday at around 1 p.m. Central Standard Time. Let's look at these blizzards, guys. We will get into the rules and the players in just a second. Whoa, wait a second. Hold on. Look at the Alps right here. What? Wait, these blizzards are absolutely bonkers. Oh my goodness. Wait, hold on. Alternatively, Burgundy. What, dude? The Alps. Screw the Alps. Look at Burgundy. Wait, you have to come through if you want. Dude. What? Wait, the whole board is split on a 1 point hold on Burgundy, right? Am I understanding that correctly? Dude, I just woke up. I have a coffee right here. I'm like trying to gather myself. Wait, hold on. Paris too. Oh my God. Yeah, I won 1,000,000% cap on Paris. Only white can roll me. Oh my goodness, you guys. This game could be absolutely legendary. What are these blizzards, man? Oh my goodness. It's a decent cap route. I'm going to be in the action. The Burgundy does kind of split it in half a little bit better, right? Because alternatively now people can come around and then push through over here. But dude, I'm still totally down to try that Paris cap. I mean, look at my other options. I don't really have anything else that's too crazy. Because yeah, if I cap on that too, they can still come around, push through my other side. Okay, but red does cap there. Interesting. Okay, hold on, guys. Let's write some stuff down here before turn one pops off any further. White's going, where's my turn one bonus? Where's my turn one bonus here? Maybe down here I could try to smoke all that. No, actually, my turn one's pretty clear. I just take right here on Western Europe. That's pretty obvious, right? Yeah. That is what we do. I hope everybody's doing well today, by the way. We're rocking the Yeti troops. I don't see a reason to not put everything right here and then do it like this. And I'm rocking the cookie dice. That is correct, folks. The cookie will lead us to victory. Ooh, there's blue. Interesting. I'm gonna go ahead and go for it. And then now that connects, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fortify this too, which isn't doing anything anyway, back onto my cap. It'll give me a 5. You have to push through a 3 on either side if you want to actually get to my cap. So I feel pretty decent about that. I mean, blue could come looking. I am going to go ahead and just fist bump, though, to whoever would like to accept it. You know, more so to the blue player, I suppose. But yes, you guys, we are on Europe Advanced Progressive Capitals. Let's get into the rules and the players here, folks. So yes, it is 60-second turn timer, AI set to medium if anybody bots out, although we do have a full lobby of humans. This is ranked. Progressive cards, balance, blitz, dice. Anybody can play in this ranked game. Alliances are off. Fog of War on. Blizzards are on and portals are off. It's the Risk meta settings, folks. Only I prefer a medium bot. All the bots are trash. It doesn't really matter at the end of the day. But I have found that the medium bot will prevent these weird stalematey situations when it comes down to you, another player, and a bot. Okay, so let's see what we can infer real quick. Let's write some stuff down here. So we have red, we have blue. What else could we see? I'm sure that we probably could have inferred where somebody's stack was based on where they attacked, but I mean, I'm talking to the camera, I'm doing a bunch of other stuff, so I missed it, I think. Actually, you know what, here, let's just go down turn order. So white, question mark. Black, we're aware. Obviously. Berry bonkers. That's why we're aware. Okay, and then purple, question mark. Yep, blue is not a question mark. Blue, so me, blue, and red, dude, a lot of tension there. There's going to be a lot of tension between those three players. Blue's in the Netherlands. What is green doing? Green's a question mark. And then red, we know, is up here in Mercia. Okay. Makes sense. This is going to be a banger, dude. I can absolutely feel it. And yes, you guys, we are live on both Twitch and YouTube. So to anybody who is tuning in live, I hope you're doing well today. Or to anybody who is watching the VOD back, hope you're doing good. We're trying to have some fun out here today, folks. Got some good games planned. Probably going to go for, I don't know, 3 or 4 hours, something like that. Okay. White starting with 9. Red starting with 8. Interesting. Okay, Mr. White player taking his time. Okay, there we go. Look at us starting with 10, dude. Who would have thought? Who would have thought? I think it's time to continue being aggressive. Ooh, wait a second. Wait a second here, folks. A little bit of an aggressive play early on here, but I'm crazy. I am an absolute psycho. So we're going to end Blue's game. That seems pretty fun to do. And then what we're going to do is we are going to... Let's actually just leave that like that. Bring that over. So red has to come down, and I don't want people to push through that 2 to see our cap, but I did just want to end Blue's game real quick. That seems like fun, yeah. Blue is starting with 7, so if they want to try to roll that, they can, but I'm hoping that they just bought out. Now, alternatively, the other option that I had there was to go ahead and push through here and take Southwestern Europe, but in my experience, just if you can just bully somebody really early on in the game and just take their cap, it can be a pretty decent option. So we lock down one of those now. The goal for this game is on our next turn, we have to really hope that red doesn't try to push through right here. Yeah, you're just going to roll that back. It's a low cap. Yeah, you lose one troop. You lose one. You lose one on that cap. Now, obviously, when caps are smaller, they're a little bit more volatile. Is that the correct word to use? Meaning that, you know, if that was a 100 cap and you only had twice the troops, it's not going to be as good of a roll. But whenever the caps are really low, it can be a little bit better or a little bit easier to work with. So that's going to come back to bite us in the butt because blue rolled it successfully. And yeah, so we will see. We'll see how that goes. The following turn is going to be putting all of our troops on this 3 right here and push through all of that. I don't see any movement in West Africa, which is good because that's going to be our game plan. Do you come down and come looking now? Yeah, you lose one troop. I'm going to fist bump. Okay, nice. So you lock your stack. That's huge for me. I needed that to happen, actually. And then blues. Oh, man. Oh, dude. Blue player. It is what it is. You know what I mean? Gosh. Oh, hey, White. Yo, we can fist bump. Yeah, I'll give you that. You can have that. I'll have this. Oh, man, that is too funny, man. Okay, and then White's just trying to figure out what's going on. Okay, so we totally burn White out of there. White moves down, yeah. That's a 3. Yeah, and then look at Blue, man. Look at Blue. Oh, dude. Oh, man. Okay, so I have 8. I think I need... Okay, so Blue, yeah, Blue and I come to an agreement. Look, hey, man, early game stuff. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is, Blue. Okay, all right. Now we got to try to make it happen. Okay, so that's a 3. I am going to prioritize that. I lose 2. Let's just try to get purple out of there. My only shot here is to try to get it. With the cookie dice. Come on, the cookie dice is OP. Dang it. I don't want White to take a card right here. If White wants to try to take a card and make use of that one, which they probably don't, as I've just shown, that I'm interested in it, then maybe they take right over here. But yeah, just whatever. I'm just trying to play out a few different scenarios if White were to try to do anything over there. And now because White is using that human hand fist bump, I'm going to do the same. Working a little bit more of that psychology aspect to my game. If somebody does the zombie fist bump, I try to do the zombie fist bump. If somebody does the pirate arg fist bump, I'll try to do that one to target or, you know, specify it to whoever. Blue wants to come looking. Oh no, this could be tragic. No, you're gonna roll it because I rolled you. Oh no, you do. Okay, so look, that's a very smart move by the blue player. But obviously, I mean, I think that they, I don't remember turn 1. I don't think they had visibility onto my cap, but they're just trying to figure out what's going on, right? So now here's what I do. I have less troops to work with on this turn. I'm going to try and take both of these bonuses, fortify that 2 back, because I have to leave a 3 right here for the blue player. Oh, but I'm going to open up their cap again. I mean, I get a plus four either way, right? Blue's gonna have tensions with the red player. Let's try to think about this. Red probably, red might actually hit this now and come looking now that blue did that. But you have to imagine that blue is gonna have more issues with red over here. Like, blue's kind of sandwiched. So maybe actually trying to hold this bonus doesn't make any sense anyway. If people are gonna try to push through right there. And think about this a little bit more long term, and maybe it's more valuable to leave my cap open anyway and then make inferences from the battle log, which that's one of my biggest tips for anybody who's trying to get better at the risk meta settings, is to really understand and learn how to read the battle log. Blue starting with 14. I don't think I want to open up your cap if that's the case, so we are going to make a slight adjustment here. Okay, hit, smack it. Nice, well played. Okay. I will go to war with white. You know, gosh, this sucks. This sucks so bad. I'm gonna have to put everything here, fortify all that back onto my cap. Okay, a 10 will be good. Blue can't put enough on that one to roll me, and then I leave my cap open. So I'm just taking a plus four somewhere else, understanding that with how strong blue is. I mean, if blue, not to mention that I kind of like screwed my relationship with blue early, just with a silly play, right? Like, I understand that probably wasn't the best play, but you got to take risks, folks. You got to take risks. But yeah, I mean, with blue starting with 14, yeah, see, look at that. And that's exactly why I did not do that. That's exactly why I did not do that, because if I open up blue right there, they put 14 on their cap, which already had like over 10 on it. Then they just can roll me. Do you know what I mean? Now this is great, because now this is causing tensions between blue and white. I'm going to pay close attention to how much white starts with, by the way. Everyone's kind of holding bonuses right now, and they all have their caps. That's very interesting. But yes. Okay, now red comes out, and they see my 10. Yeah, so that area of the board, there's going to be so much action. People are going to push through right there constantly. I think it's very silly for me to try to hold that. Yeah, that's going to be crazy, man. That is going to be absolutely insane. Now, I think that what I have to do, if that's the case, is I have to push through. And I do have a set, which is really nice. Never in my life would I ever take the baby set. I am going to stop white from holding this bonus. And we're going to do it like this. Sit there. Keep my cap strong. And I have to trade over there. So we will see what white does. Now, white will have a trade, and they're going to have to decide if they want to go through, up here or through blue. But I don't have any options, right? Like my alt, see, and he says good luck. So that's a lose-lose situation for me regardless, right? If I want to go north from my capital, then I open up blue, who's a huge threat. I'm just clogging up an area that needs to be the highway of this map, so to speak. And then if I go south, then I have beef with white. So, but in this scenario, having beef with white is much better, because blue is also going to come down here because they don't want beef with red, I'm assuming. Yes, and there we see it. Are you going to roll me? No, you don't. Yeah, that's why that's the better solution for me, because now the white player shouldn't have a bonus unless they have what, like the Dinaric Alps. Which I guess they could, in the center of the board, considering that white's kind of over here in this Italy position in Western Africa. So yeah, I'll be very curious to see what white starts with now. They're going to have a trade, and it's just going to come down to who they want to go into. Blue revealed themselves to have a very large stack from holding this Central Europe bonus, most likely. Okay, and then red is just continuing to use that as a trading zone. Yeah, I think I always leave my cap open now. And we gotta chill for a little bit. Yeah, you just hit my five. Yeah, you do. So that sucks. So I'm losing out on this for sure. And then you break me. That's unfortunate. What are you starting with, white? You're starting with 11, so even with blue doing that, Okay, then let's do it like this. We are going to show friendly nature to the white player for a little bit here. What are my cards now? What are my cards? I don't have a set on three. Blue can roll us right now and end our game. Yeah, blue's already got a 30. They're going to set and they're going to get the... so they'll have over 40 to be able to roll our cap. They're getting like plus 10 and so they'll have like a 50. So our game might end right here, folks. Going against the blue player early may prove to suck. You're going to have like a 40 to 50. Oh, this is really scary and your cap's open. Let's see it, folks. Does our game end here? You come down off your cap 1,000,000%. Without a doubt. What I have to hope right now is that red and blue up. Oh, nice. Okay, so 37. So that's fine. Just take a card pass. With how much action is happening on the left side of the board, I'm curious to understand if anybody is beginning to get a stronger... Yeah, maybe green is on the right side of the board. Yeah, purple with 21. So purple and green, I'm going to write down. I'm just going to just say... RB question mark and then green RB question mark. There's a lot that we don't know about the board because we are capped right on the highway where all the movement is happening. So, oh, goodness. Yeah. So, you know, but eventually those players that are starting to do very well on the right side, they are going to come up here into the new corner, right? Yep. 25. Keeping my cap strong is the priority for sure. Since they are continuing to open up this every single turn anyway, I think it's okay for me to... Yeah, I think I'm going to begin taking a card over there instead. I need to start putting everything on my cap. White starting with 22. Oh my goodness. And remember... Oh no. Okay, yeah, so you're just matching me. So yeah. That's fine. I'm going to put everything on this. If blue's cap's getting opened up every turn anyway, then I'm just going to take a card over there and avoid the pressure against the white player as the white player is now starting to accrue some bonuses with where I'm assuming is around the middle of the board. Not to mention Western Africa that we are now giving them, which is a plus 6. So, now how does this shake out? Now we are approaching round what, like 4 or 5? Round 7? Yeah, 7. So around this section of the game, the sets are going to begin getting very crazy and I need to be careful. Blue soon is going to be able to roll my cap. Very, very soon. Do I have a set on 4? I think I take a set on 4 here. Because if I don't, blue has enough to roll my cap. It would be decent with a set, if they have a set on 4, I mean. They get 20 troops on there. They already have 40. They'd have double my troops. Plus, yeah, they'd have a little over double my troops. I have to set here if I want to stay alive. Okay, so we kind of get out of that being able to hold a bonus, which is really nice. What do you do, White? White sets, how much do you poke out? What do we see poke out from the north side of Southern Europe? You make that a 7? Was that just from your set, I guess? I'm not gonna match. Really? Really? You put 10 down there. Why? Just let that sit for a second so everybody can see that I got a 59. Okay, good. Now we come back. Exit Royal says, hi there. Hey, Exit Royal. Hope you're doing well today. Hope you're doing well. Playing some Europe Advanced Progressive Capitals. Okay, so that set's going to keep us alive for a little bit. What are our two cards now? We have two. Okay, nice. We have two cavalry. Sets are getting up there, folks. Sets are getting up there to like 30. White adding troops over there. We're just going to continue stacking. So we have a Cold War brewing with me and White, and I lose out on that for sure. My cap will continue. You know, blue's right here. Blue's pretty... Wait, blue's starting with 10 still, right? 13? Yeah. So blue's a problem for me. It's really just blue and white. That's who I'm worried about right now. Red's cap is closed. Because red's cap isn't... What would we say? Mercia? Yeah, Mercia. So whatever red gets, whenever red sets, they have to put down here in London. And so that's not too much of a threat. But blue's cap is always getting opened. And white is starting with just an insane amount. Like 20 plus. Yeah, white's starting with 22. So this gets to be very, very scary for us. So we shall see. Lifrilo says sup from Twitch. What up, Lifrilo? Frostbite Dragon. Hi there. Hey, Frostbite. Hope you're doing well. Hope everybody's doing well. We are multi-streaming on both Twitch and YouTube. So if you see me talk to somebody that you don't see in chat with you, it's because they're on a different platform, my friends. Okay, yeah. So red, we're not worried about red at all. Red's just guarding their bonus, and they have that 10 there to just take cards. So need to go in the middle position if that's possible. Yeah. So right now, white has laid claim to that, but there's hope. So purple and green are on the right side of the board, and they've gotten very strong. And you guys, I mean, if you're just tuning in, look at these blizzards. These blizzards are actually bonkers. So if you look at it, you have to push through the Alps or Burgundy, and that kind of splits the map in half. So these players that are on the right side of the board getting very strong, talking about purple and green over here, eventually they have to push through white or push through red or blue, and then they get to me. So a lot of tension is going to break here soon. And then I will make my move to check the king. But yeah, so right now, and also the beginning, if you missed the beginning of the game, it was kind of hilarious. The blue player left like a 4 or a 5 on their cap, and I smacked it. The next turn, the blue player puts like, I forget, like 6 troops on a 1 or something, and they roll my cap, which I had a 4 or 5 on. They lose one troop, they take it back. And so now there's like insane tension between me and the blue player. So if blue has an opportunity to kill us, they probably do. We'll see how that goes. Let's see. Me and Lif are on all the cap games. That's what's up. That's what's up. What's up, Veridak? Hope you're doing well. Keep up the amazing work, Robo Risk. Love watching your vids. Thank you so much. And you guys, thank all of you. To everybody in chat. Oh, now we see purple. Interesting. So purple coming looking. And now you see my cap. So now I'm not going to take offense to that. Because purple's just trying to understand what's going on in the board. And also, they kind of did me a favor. Because what purple did right there was purple came through over here through Trieste and came down. And they basically broke all of white's bonuses to come looking. So my cap is still in a healthy position with... and I'm going to have hopefully a set next turn, hopefully. Unless I get a dude. And so I'm okay with that. I'm okay. But anyways, yes, thank you guys, everyone, whoever's watching live or whoever's watching the VOD back, everybody who's been watching the videos, you guys are absolutely insane. Our newest video also is doing really well, the banana thumbnail, the legendary banana thumbnail video. So yeah, just thank you guys so much. It has actually been mind-blowing, the support that you guys have been giving to the channel. I can't say thank you enough. Purple is the saving grace here. Absolutely. Go for the middle now, I guess. I think now actually is the time to go looking. We will see what we see from white, but you're right. I think now I'm going to take this turn to just go looking and see if I can identify the other capitals, because what we're missing right now is we're missing the white cap, ? Purple cap, ? Green cap, ? So if I can use this turn to go looking, now's the time to do it. And I think based on how much green's attacking right here, green's probably doing the same. Dang, I miss Europe Advanced Caps. Yes, you're the black player. I am black, you guys. I am Blackberry Bonkers wearing a bucket hat today. That is who we are playing as. What do you think of the new Dune map? There's potential for one of the maps. Now, some of the other Risk content creators, they don't like the maps that are really snowbally and are, you know, volatile, I guess you could say. Dude, I fucking love those maps. And there's this one Dune map that, you hold like the whole right side of the board on 2 or 3 points. I forget the name of it. But, and also, you guys, shout out the devs. The devs did give me early access to those maps. And so I was checking them out, and I was actually thinking about recording a video on it. But the thing is you can only record with the early access maps. You can only record with bots. And so that's kind of a bummer. I'm going to go looking probably... I'm going to go looking right now. Hold on, what is White starting with? I get to talk into chat. Oh, you're still starting with 15. Now's not the time. Okay, change of plans, change of plans, change of plans. It's okay. It's okay. So that three there, having that three there is actually kind of annoying because I'm probably going to lose that. Let me just do it like this. A seven is enough to hold that and then back out. Yes. Okay. And then now I fist bump. And then so that I don't lose that three, I'm going to move that three back. Now I have a four guard, and then I'll go looking soon, guys. I'll go looking soon. With the context of White still starting with that much, I'm very confused. Because remember, Purple's cap is still a mystery. I wonder if Purple actually just was back here the whole time. Let's see. Green most likely is in Russia. I agree, actually. I agree with that take. Green is starting with 15. They were starting with 22. Which is good. So that means that there's tension between green and purple, as green and purple are who I'm predicting to be on the right side of the board. Can you do it in a custom? No, I wish. The way that it works is when things are in early access status with the developers, you can only play games with other content creators that have the early access or with bots. So I would need to get a group of content creators together for us to play, which could be fun, man. That could be fun. So we shall see, my friends. But yeah, we'll see. Let's see. Honestly, you're the best Risk player. Thank you for sharing your experience. I don't know about all that, man. I think I'm all right. I'm super thankful, and I have so much thanks for being able to get to Grandmaster and for the support that you guys give me. But man, there are some crazy, crazy Risk players out there, dude. Like Kilted, Pete, all the top Grandmasters, man. Cosmic Cowboy, JJ. I mean, dude, there's so many. Wait, who wrote that? So, Veradak, I'm multi-streaming on multiple platforms. So if you don't see the chat that I'm replying to, it's a different platform. But yeah. But no, man, no, I am far, far from the best Risk player. I would say that my unique spin is just that, you can watch my videos and learn how to play like a Grandmaster and a novice at the same time. That's what I offer. So, let's see. Okay, live. How many are streaming Risk? Wait, what? Oh, are you following me? Oh, yeah. So you're talking to Liv. Gotcha. Oh my goodness gracious, folks. Rudy and chat with the Dancing Dinos. What's up, Rudy? Hope you're doing well today. Hope everything's well with the baby, Rudy. Rudy's got the dad life going on. I respect it. Okay, so White is now trying to take that back, and White's starting with what? White's starting with 15. So White isn't necessarily holding all their bonuses. Trades are for... Oh, my God. Wait. Is it time for me to go for a kill here? No, it's not. Hold on. White's got five cards. Hold on. I think I could kill White. I think I could. This is so risky. Yeah, purple's down there. Where's your cap? Oh, you have a 100! Oh! Oh, no! Oh, the drama! That's a oops. Such an oops! Oh, that's such an oops! All my shit is getting broken, guys. All my shit is getting broken. You should trade just to survive. Oh no! Oh, look, folks, you get to talking to Chad, and you make we're throwing for content. That's what it is. Honestly, though, we're totally fine. I mean, White is gonna set, and then what? You know, okay, but actually, though, that is such huge information. So White is in Vienna. So although we do piss off White, we do say the oops and we do say the wow. We've made a lifelong enemy out of White, though. But knowing that wide is in Vienna is actually huge, dude. The pressure that is in the middle of the board is absolutely bonkers. We have white in Vienna. You guys, look at this. This is nuts. We have white in Vienna. We have blue in the Netherlands. And we have red in Mercia. Like, dude, what? Or Mercia. How do you say that? I don't know. So now we just need to try to stay alive. White's going to set and absolutely punch us. Oh, and white's going to break all of our bonuses, too. That's actually tragic. But, you know, blue saw that there was a lot of pressure happening there because they saw me poke out through over here. So blue understands that white and I are attacking each other. And then also purple. What is purple even doing down here, bro? Purple just got a 20 and a loot. Why? You have to think that purple's just trying to hold this bonus down here. But this late in the game, I mean, trying to hold it. What is that? Plus three. Yeah, trying to hold plus three North Africa is not necessarily the best play. Okay, and then red shows their cheeky little 10 up there. And red and blue did come to an agreement up there. Red is holding this British Empire and Iceland. Okay, now I get boobopped. I get absolutely boobopped. I'm going to say thanks. Oh, no. Yo, why, do you remember when I came up there trying to kill you? I mean, we're cool, right? Hey, white, fist bump? Thanks? Dang it! Okay, so what that... I like that play from white. Oh, is white going to try to block me from having a bonus now? That would be a really good play. Yeah, that's a really good play. So I'm going to think at that. Because, yeah, that's getting boobopped on my next... No, white player's mad. Oh, goodness gracious, white. Goodness gracious. Okay, look, white, it is what it is, man. It is what it is. That 20 is going to get smoked on my next trade, so you are going to have to work with me. And also, holding my bonus, although it is white being aggressive towards me, it's a plus four, right? Look at the sets, guys. 75. Like, I really don't care at the end of the day. At this point, you know, we just need to time a set with a kill that will set us again, and then... it doesn't matter. Oh my goodness. Oh my God. Purple wants to come looking. Really? Get ready for the thinking, folks. Get ready for the think. And now I think. Yep, I have a 100 there, Purple. Now Purple backs all the way up. Maybe Purple thought I was weaker than I actually was when they saw that I attacked white and then white came back. I don't know. But now we laugh. Because, dude, this game is just this game is insane. There is so much tension on the left side of the board, and we just have two people, green and purple, just holding the entire right side. The good news about that, though, is that they have to go through, break white's bonuses, or go up here and break blue's bonuses. So the way that this cookie crumbles when the tension finally snaps is with the other players, not with me. And then I'm uniquely in a good position too, because I'm right on the edge of the highway. So when things happen and people try to push through Burgundy, I'm in a pretty good spot. What are you starting with, white? White's starting with 15. You set your cap's open. Wait, I might die here. I might die. Nope, I don't die. Okay. Yeah, I don't die. White is not happy with me, though. Really? What are you doing? White's in a really bad spot, guys. For real. White is in a really, really bad spot. Oh my goodness. I'm going to slider every last little thing I do. I have to leave a three there. That's so cringe. Dang it. I have to leave a three in the pocket. Okay, now white, look at my fist bump. And I saw earlier, I think you like doing the human fist bump. Yes, dude. Well played. Robo love. And then we back on out of there. And I'm even going to leave a three there. I trust you, white. You and I, we're boys now. White and I, we're going, dude, until the end, me and white. Set on four. Yes, I do have a set on 4, 85. If white sets on 3, they can kill me. They could kill me right here. No set on 3. Nice. Okay, we're chilling. Did I say white? I meant blue. What did I say? What is it called whenever you when it's hard to read things? What is that called? Dyslexia, right? Isn't that what that's called? I feel like I have a version of that. Or like when I speak, I'll like say the wrong thing. It happens a lot with the colors white and yellow. And there's other content creators that I've seen do that too. I've seen Kilted do that. And I wonder what that is, man. I wonder if it's just maybe my brain is tiny or I don't know. Have fun with the rest of your stream. Got to go. Frostbite Dragon. Have a good one. Okay, Red leaving a big stack right there. Yes, have a good weekend, Frostbite Dragon. Have a good weekend wherever you are in the world, my friend. I'm going to try to win this game for you, Frostbite. Blackberry Bonkers wearing the bucket will get the dub. Okay, we set absolutely every day of the week to try to stay alive here, folks. Every single day of the week. Oh, also, by the way, to whoever's watching this VOD back. Ooh, let's think for a second. Ooh, wait a second. I don't think it's worth doing anything. Wait. I mean, white's on 2 cards. That's not worth. Blue, that wouldn't be 100% roll. Red has a pretty big cap. Yeah, it's not time. It is not time. You guys, how does everyone have their cap still? How? We're 30 minutes into this game. Leader is still 1 out of 6 in the top left. That is insane. This game is bizarre. This game is insane. White's thinking. I need another place to take a card so that way I can keep my cap open for if something pops off. Blue's on 5 cards. Wait, blue's on 5 cards and they have a 100 on their cap. Hold on, that might actually be worth now because the sets are going to be for 100. Is that worth? I don't think I could chain that kill though. I would need blue to be a little bit weaker. And you're starting with what, blue? You're starting with 13 still. So that means that blue's probably got a lot off cap right now to try and hold their bonus, I suppose. Which is a little silly when the sets are for 100. Let me think. What is purple starting with? Purple's starting with 21. See, there's no way. There's no way that I can chain that into a kill. That's actually meaningful. Everybody else has got low cards. We need a war to break out. I need to see somebody's not holding a bonus, you know? Green did have, was starting with 6. I mean, yeah, so green is at war with who? Purple, maybe? And they were doing a lot of attacking right there. Green's got 2 cards. If white opens me up, maybe I go for blue. See, but what sucks is, so I am open, so I do have, you guys, I could do something here. I could do something. I don't think it's time though. Because then if I hit blue, I could fail. I would likely get it though. It would be a really good roll, but I wouldn't be able to hold both those caps. Whatever I would get from the set, I'd have to bring all the way back onto my cap. It would push the game along, but it wouldn't put me in a favorable position to snowball, I don't think. I don't think it's time. I don't think it's time, but we're getting there. I think we will be in a position to really make something happen. We'll be in a position to make something happen. Okay. All right, White. Look, you and me, White, after all the tensions we had. You and me. I like that, though. You know, I throw my 200 stack out there, and I think at the lobby. And somebody fist bumps me, that tells me that they're maybe a little bit of a better player. If they're trying to work in, you know, try to communicate with me, I'm willing to work with somebody that's willing to communicate with me. I didn't see anything from blue, didn't see anything from red. What are my predictions for the ranks for these players? Let's think about that for a second. Red doesn't really strike me as a super high rank. I could be wrong about that. Blue, I don't know, man. Blue's kind of a question mark for me. That may prove to bite me in the butt, though. That was probably my best shot to roll blue, because now blue's going to get 100 to put on that cap. So blue's just right back in this game. Purple's still in their draft phase. Starting with 21, that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Uh-oh. Purple's in a great spot on the board. They even have a set on 5. There we go. Do something, purple. You got to take a card. Got to take a card, and you don't take a card. Okay. So, poor purple. Not sure what happened there. Maybe their Hot Pocket was ready in the microwave. Their pizza rolls. I can relate to that. Okay. Blue sets, that should all go on your cap. No. Okay. Blue going for a kill, maybe. No. All goes on your cap. That should be like a 180. Yeah, 180, I called it. Okay. Starting with 5. Okay, so who was doing a lot of attacking before? So green and blue. So as I was saying, you know, what was it, 10 minutes ago? Green and purple are kind of on this right side of the board, and the tension eventually needs to break, and it's going to come up through the noob corner, or it's going to come through white. Now purple is down here in North Africa. I have to hope that maybe white eventually just clears them out. And then I actually think we're in a pretty good spot on the board right now as far as avoiding conflict or staying out and then constantly being opened to be able to make something happen. So, okay, white doing a lot of attacking, not into me. And that is now too many attacks for it to be anything down here in North Africa. So white's attacking over here to the east of their position. Their cap is in what, Trieste, we said? No, Vienna, yeah. So white's doing a lot of attacking into somebody. I really want to go looking the right side of the board and try to identify where the other caps are. I think it's time for me to like go and figure that out, because everyone's still pretty low on cards. But see, you have a 12 there. That's so annoying. I need to go looking. I'm going to take this turn to go looking. I know that there's probably a better time to do that. Okay, we see green. Nice. Where's purple? There's purple. Okay, so that was a great turn. I got everything I needed. Okay. And what I'm doing there is I'm just trying to show the white player that I was just going looking and trying to figure that out and just trying to get, you know, and the other players, if they're a higher rank, they're going to understand. And see, now white's mad at me, but it is what it is. I had to blow through white's troops. I had to do that eventually. It's just a matter of when do you do it, and I choose to do it when white's on one card. You know what I mean? Because the alternative is what? I go up through red's cap, which I can't do, or through blue's cap, which I can't do. So let's write that down. So purple is in Istanbul. And then green is in Russia, Kharkiv. Okay, so purple's over in the Orient, yeah. We know where all the caps are now, folks. We know them all, we know them all. That's huge. And I choose to do that when, and now blue's gonna go looking, keep attacking. And also, what the purple just left a 67 there? Dude, whenever I was writing, I must have missed something crazy. Maybe that's why white was mad. Was that purple just left that there? Dude, I'm so mind blown at that. Okay, and then blue is continuing to attack. So this is good. So yes, let's have short-term memory on what was going on right there. So now blue understands that that's my whole position. Yeah, blue can come looking. It's fine. That was pretty funny. I was like, that is obviously my position. And blue's just like, man, fuck it. I'll break it anyway. Oh my goodness, dude. We're coming up on 45 minutes on this game and everybody still has their caps. How? How? I gotta say though, a lot of tensions on the right side of the board though. We have white over there, green, black, purple. Okay, green's not gonna be able to get their bonus back. Wait, did purple bot? Purple botted and I'm an idiot, bro. I'm such an idiot. I'm like, why is there 67 there? Purple clearly botted. It's so evident. And actually, it's been so long. We're like 45 minutes into this game. I got into the rules. Let's get into the players, ladies and gentlemen. In the first position, we have the white player, Wesley Zambergen from the Netherlands. In the second position, we have Blackberry Bonkers wearing the bucket hat. Your boy, Robo, Grandmaster Ring player. In the third position, we have the purple player, General Bo, 18673 from the United States of America. In the fourth position, we have the blue player, Glover Amaya from Spain. In the fifth position, we have the green player, Iridescent Beagle 316 from Slovenia, I think. In the sixth position, we have the red player, Ahmet Michael Keksin. And the red player is from Turkey. And it is Blackberry Bonkers wearing a bucket hat's turn. So let's lock in here, folks. Let's lock in. And let's get that three out of there. It's doing absolutely nothing for us. Okie dokie. Testram says, yo, what's up, Testram? Hope you're doing well today. Hope you're having the best day you've ever had in your life, Testram. Okay, so we know where the whole board's at, guys. We have white in Vienna. We have purple in Istanbul on the west, northwest side of the Orient. We have blue in the Netherlands. We have green in Kharkiv, Russia. And then red is in Mercia. Testram with the flex. Testram flexing on us. Yes. Love that. Okay, so here is... Now we have a few things to consider, right? Purple botted for whatever reason. Purple had a decent position on the board, and they had a set on... I don't understand why purple botted. I don't know, man. They had to go to work. They had to go to school. They had to do something. We have a set on five. What does blue do? And also, what is my set? It's just a cavalry set? Okay. I will get some extra troops in Izurum, right? Where is that at? Have it over here? Yeah, down here in the Orient. Okay. Maybe blue is... Ooh, blue might be taking the Istanbul cap. Yep, they're attacking. Look at how many times they've attacked. Blue might be split here. Blue might be split. I don't think it's the time to hold two caps, though. Everyone has their own caps, and everyone is very strong. I mean, green's got 300 on their cap now. My goodness. Red should be very strong, too. I mean, think about it, guys. The red player has been staying out of the action and taking a card and passing just over there in the UK. So red is very strong. White's still here. Purple's not here. Here. Okay, yeah. So roll call shows that it is just the purple bot. Which everyone else is going to have to deal with all these troops before I do, which is great. So nice. Okay. Sets it for 125. Folks, if you're just tuning in the live stream, we are the Blackberry Bonkers wearing a bucket hat, trying to make it happen here on the risk meta settings today. And, ooh, you could roll me. Ooh, I was on five cards too. That would have been a double set. Ooh, that would have been the time to do it, maybe. Uh-oh. The silence on the board is deafening as the big whales come out. White continuing to attack. You know what I think I want to do? I'd like to have an exterior position. I'd like to leave... That is a 3 hundo. And I want to start taking cards up there. I don't want to lose my visibility on the right side of the board because we saw what happened last time. I had to push through white and it made white mad. But, you know, whenever I take cards up here, I'm going to go north and see it, hope that green doesn't smack us. And I was trying to get away from this 79. Don't smack me. Don't smack me, purple bot. Don't do it, my 19. Okay, but that's good, though, guys. We set, and that's going to keep us alive for a little bit longer. And we have a back-to-back set. Okay, hold on. So we actually could kill somebody. We could kill... No, we wouldn't... No, not really. I mean, purple would be the only one... Okay, so we have a purple bot down there. I actually do think I want to remove the bot down there. I do. Ooh, I want to keep a kill guard on the bot down there, actually. That's what I want to do. Bot's on 5 cards, so that could blow up in my face. I have to remove the bot down there. I have to. Because the bot's going to set. If nobody kills the bot here... if nobody kills the bot here... I don't think I want to be the one to do it. I'm going to let somebody else do it, but I do want to remove the bot from my side of the board. Let the bot set and blow those 130 troops. All over everyone else, white and green, over there. That's how we do that for sure. Or do I just do it to push the game along? I could kill it. I could kill purple. Be 5 cards, set, and then what? Everyone else is so strong, man. That's the issue. Everyone. Everyone is still so, so strong. I think I had some music playing this whole time. My bad, guys. Maybe I just kill the bot. Maybe I do it. I wouldn't be able to fortify a whole lot back onto me, though. That's the issue. God, I don't think it's time. I'm gonna try to hold that. Maybe I do keep a cheeky kill guard on the bot. Nope, I can't risk it. Let's have the bot set and just ruin somebody else's day. Yep, and then I'll set on my next turn. Do you just come down here anyway to where I still have to deal with you? See, the issue is that white has a 300 stack right there, so the bot is stacking against it. And the bot wants that bonus too. This is pretty annoying for white. Yeah, darn, I'm gonna end up having to deal with this stupid bot anyway. God, that is so annoying, man. My 19 gets smoked here or what? Yep, it does. So annoying. Ugh. I do keep a couple ones over there, though. We have some expensive cards coming up here. If we get knocked out of the right side. Yep. I think I'm going to go and try to take North Africa just for fun. I am Barry Bonkers after all. We gotta make some bonk. Oh, you could kill me.
Oh, this is so terrifying. Oh, this is so terrifying, dude.
Red is actually so strong just from staying out of the mix. Is the white going? Dude, is white going for the purple kill? That was interesting. Maybe, dude. Yeah, I think white is. That's too much attacking. It has to be into purple. We need some emojis up in this stream, bro. That is true, man. That is so true. I need to get those made. Okay, so red is just way too strong. So I'm going to do it like this. I think I just take a card right here. If I get smoked over here, so be it. Actually, you know what I'm going to try to do? No. If somebody goes and tries to clear that out, they're going to get right here and they're going to think that they only need a couple more troops and then my five's going to be there to block it. So that's just really funny. And then this is to stay alive. This is just to stay alive. But yeah, you guys are right. There's a lot that I really want to do with the stream. When I chill in the other Risk content creator streams, especially on like Twitch, obviously TestRam is on YouTube, but especially on Twitch, there's all these really cool things that they do. Like they build up channel points and then they have like redeems and stuff that you can use them for. So we're going to get all that set up and also on YouTube, get some stuff set up too. So I have plans to reach out to a... okay. So yeah, so we have some expensive cards now, guys. We have some very, very expensive cards here. Blue, let's see if blue smacks the 44 though. No, so blue is attacking to the north, east probably. But yeah, and also guys, speaking of adding things to the stream and stuff, our channel right now is sitting at like a little over 200 subscribers. We just hit 200 subscribers recently, by the way, so thank you so much for that. Whenever we hit 500 subscribers and then 1,000, we can become a YouTube partner and we can add a bunch of really cool stuff. And, for a little bit of a backstory, if you guys aren't familiar with me, I've actually been in the YouTube game for a really long time. I've had a bunch of channels and I also help a lot of other big creators. And I have a producer role right now. I help a YouTuber that's got about 1 million subscribers. So I'm really familiar with how sort of these things work. It's just my own personal channels. I haven't been able to really do much of it for me yet. But whenever I hit those milestones, you know, 500 subscribers, 1,000 subscribers, it's all going to happen at once, man. I'm going to drop a bunch of stuff. We're going to have a store. We're going to do really, really high quality t-shirts and coffee mugs and stuff like that. You know, I really want to put out things that people would want to buy anyway, even if they don't know who I am. And then if they want to support me, then it's kind of a win-win, right? I do get knocked out of the right side. That's what I was afraid of. Really, really good play by the green player here. That's such a good play, man. It gives me a really expensive card. I don't know if green had the vision to see that. But that's really unfortunate for me. Let's see if red opens me up here. Or does red break blue? But yeah, but emotes, we're going to work with a graphics artist, get a bunch of emotes, and then add some cool stuff to the stream, add, you know, a bunch of really, really awesome stuff. So I'm super excited about it. But man, right now, I'm just having fun, dude. I'm just having fun. Yes, thank you, Red. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I was going to have to do that if Red didn't. Huge W for us. And that helps a lot, too, because Red's been staying out of the action, so they burn some troops there. Dude, anywhere Red can burn troops is a win for us. But yeah, guys, right now I'm just having fun regardless. But yeah, whenever it comes time for that stuff, we are going to go all in. Okay, so blue still very weak. They are investing. We saw that blue set whenever they had the 100 and they put it just in a completely different area. So a lot of questions for what blue's doing. Let's see if we can infer. Ooh, the leader did switch to 2 out of 6. So that's somebody taking the purple cap. Okay, and now purple is going to begin stacking down here. So this is going to be a problem for me. And it's situations like these, guys, where people don't want to deal with the bot that I prefer the bot to be medium instead of expert. So that's why we do medium instead of expert, because notice how much slower the bot is. I believe that the difference between a medium bot and an expert bot is really just the aggression of the bot. My 10's gonna get smoked down here now. All the bots are trash, but this bot, so annoying, man. The bot is getting progressively weaker and weaker, though. The next time the bot is on 4 or 5 cards, I think I'll go ahead and just clean it out. And then we saw that red didn't like causing pressure with the blue player. That may even be where blue has their other stack, is over here in Oslo or Finland or something. So that may be why the red player is choosing to take a card and hit a 44 versus going into blue. I have to imagine that it's either green or... Well, actually, no, we did see blue come down here and keep attacking. So it's blue, green, or purple. Or white that took the purple cap. Green now starting with 5 at war with blue. Wow, based on how much attacking we just saw. We do have a war brewing. Red says, watch this. watch this, yes. Show me something, Red. Show me. Throw some robo love out there. But yeah, what kind of emoji should I do, guys? What should I do? I think I need like a gamer's emoji. We could do that. Get some other ones for like, you know, a rage emoji. Get a laughing emoji. We'll do all the basics, all the ones that you kind of need. And then we'll do some funny ones in there too. Yeah, it'll be good. I'm actually here. I'm going to write that down, guys. I'm actually going to do that. Probably today. Go and reach out. Yeah, we'll get that set up. And then I'm really excited about the t-shirts and adding stuff and having a little bit of a store, which I think YouTube lets me do that at 500 subscribers. So hopefully we can get the store, I don't know, this year or something. I'm not really holding my breath with like the channel growth or anything, by the way. I'm just having fun right now. It's been doing pretty good, which is awesome. It's been really cool to see that, you know, how accepting the Risk community has been of me. But, you know, I'm already more than happy with the growth that I've had. But yeah, getting the store is going to be a lot of fun. And then some other features that come with it when you grow just a little bit more. Okay, we'll just take a card down here. And then break the box bonus for fun. And then this 3 is not really doing anything. Okay, so purple now getting 4 means that they can't break my 8 and they don't have a set. That's kind of the idea behind just breaking that bonus. What do you do, purple bot? And I'm still really confused why General Bo even left. Now, red not attacking the 38 here, purple's 38, basically means... Ooh, you get 170. What do you do, blue? What did you start with also? Starting with 5. Wow. Wow, you're going for the bot kill. I'm getting ready for the fist bump. No, you're not going for the bot kill. I think I go for the bot kill on my next turn. With how much attacking blue just did right there, I go for the bot kill now. 1,000,000% I go for the bot kill off of my big stack, just in case. Because that's going to set me. It'll be worth it at that point. Going through this many troops, the bot is a little bit weaker now. You know, green or red might actually go for it, though. That's the thing. But red also did just say, watch this. Maybe red saying, watch this. I don't know, man. I definitely go for it, though, regardless. Truth Power's in the chat. Yo, Truth, my boy. He says, yo, it's Robo. Look who it is, man. Yeah, Truth, another content creator in the Risk space. Good to see you, buddy. Good to see you. If you guys are watching the VOD back or anybody live, make sure to go check out Truth. Truth, you got any updates on your camera, man? I was talking to you on Discord about that. You got any ideas on what you want to do for your camera? That whole predicament you're in, dude, I was in that predicament for like a year where it's like trying to find the right quality for the right price. It's tough, dude. And your camera right now is actually a pretty decent one. It's like, I think like a little over $100 or something. It's a good camera, man. It's really good. But that's, dude, that's, oh gosh, it's tough. You know, trying to find something that'll give you the quality but doesn't break the bank. But yeah, man, Truth, I've been digging the vids lately, man. I've been digging your vids. Been awesome. And then also, Truth, are you planning on playing in the World Championships coming up here pretty soon? All right, guys, we're going to kill the bot right here. Do we have a set on four? No. Yeah, we do. So we have a set on four. That'll leave us with four cards after the set, and we will have a 75% to an 80% chance of having a set after we kill purple. So it becomes worthwhile. Oh, you're going to get it. Dang it. Dang it. There's no purple down there. There's no purple. No, you didn't take the purple kill? I go for it. But I don't set just yet. Wow. You're not going to be on three cards. Do I go for it, guys? Do I just move the game along? Oh, do I move the game along? The cards are pretty good now. I'm going to go for it. I'm going for it. Whatever, dude. I don't care. Wait, purple's up there? Huh? No way, dude. What? When white came out there, so my thought process there, guys, is I thought maybe white cleared that out, and then they messed it up and they came down here, and then that might have been the bot's last position, because that's... Dang it! Okay, well, the bot's really weak now. If the bot doesn't have a set on three, obviously my three is going to get opened up from blue. Wait, blue's really weak too. Hold on, guys. I think that this game's going to pop off here really, really soon. Red says oops. I'm going to laugh at that. I think that actually... I mean, obviously that's a bit of an oops, but with the context that I had of white coming down here... Because purple just has like, oh, and then purple sets on three. No. No. Okay. Well, blue's really weak. I think red might kill blue, though. And also, I'm not really sure. I mean, red had to have just been oopsing at the fact that I didn't get the bot kill, right? That's got to be what they're oopsing at. It can't be that I like broke their bonus or whatever, because purple was already sitting there. And then blue's starting with what, like five, right? Oh, starting with seven, so... Oh, well then, hold on. If blue's starting with seven, then blue has the bot's cap in Istanbul, was where we said that's at. That's the only way that math could possibly work. Unless they're holding a bunch of territories. Because you get five for having your cap, right? And then, you know, maybe if they have like 15 territories or whatever, then they get the plus one from having the 12 territory bonus, right? Could be that, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's not likely. I think it's more likely that blue has the cap because there's no reason for them to be this weak. And earlier, a couple turns ago, we saw them come down here and continue attacking over here into the Trieste area towards Istanbul, where we know that the purple cap was. Well, we are seeing a bot out here, so I don't know. We go looking now for sure. Definitely go looking. I think we will learn a lot about the shape of the board depending on what red does here. If they kill blue, that's ideal for us because blue's just holding one card. So you're gonna have to burn through a lot of troops to... Yeah, and then you trade anyway. So if you were to kill blue here, that would be pretty good. No, you don't. Are you attacking to the left or the right? I'm getting my fist bump ready here. Do we see you poke out of the bottom? It's very unlikely, I think. Okay, we don't need to fist bump. You're attacking. You might still be going for the blue kill. Because if blue did have this other cap, red could come down here, smack, and then go up to the north. Because you would still avoid Kharkiv. Ooh, you do get the bot kill. Okay, nice. Well played. And that's just a one, right? So yeah, that's a well played. Let's see if you kill blue. No, you don't. You just fortify back. Interesting. Corpse Hero says, yo, how you been? What's up, Corpse Hero? Hope you're doing well today. Doing well. I am doing well. Just playing some Europe Advanced Progressive Capitals. And this game has been bananas. The first death finally happens. I really want to find Blue's other position here. I really do. I need to make that a 5. Yes, I was right. So blue is really weak. We're going to do that just so that way green... I don't want red to think that I'm being aggressive towards them. I'm just going looking, right? But I'm just getting a lot of information about the board right now. So green has a single stack, and blue is just absurdly weak. Blue is so weak right now, guys. Oh my goodness. So... And blue's not holding a bonus either because of green down here and red, I'm assuming. Did you bot? Yeah. Yeah, I was going to say surely blue botted. So blue will be the next to die. And then we'll be in a 4-player endgame. Me, red, white, green. I am actually going to predict that some of these players are at least the master rank, by the way. We definitely have some masters in here. Me holding all that territory down there has been really good for us also. Look at this, guys. Starting with 18. It's not bad at all. So the whole bottom left side of the map, it's just kind of dead to people. So that's great. Oh, goodness. White's pretty weak. After blue, I think white's next up, right? Because look, me and white both have 3 cards. White's got 400, I've got 600. White's just been in so much of the action that that's kind of what's going on there. And then green is a question mark. Okay. Green take a card pass. Oh no, you're going to keep attacking down. I think I am just going to put like 100 on that blue cap. We'll see if red does it first, though. I mean, red could just come around here and grab it before me because there's a 76 right here in my face. So, but let's see it, red. Do you do it? I mean, red's got the big stack. They got like 700 on their cap. Red's going to have a set. Maybe I just let red do it. I mean, I do have a set here. I could probably just do it. White's just taking their territory back. Ooh, do you clean it up? How many more? One more so you could be right here. Do you keep attacking? Nope. White just set their stack right here. They got like a 200 right there. Okay. Good to know. Although blue did have a lot of troops down here, so maybe they set like a 150 or something over there. But okay, I need a place to take a card now. I just want to have that up here as an exterior position since we have a very expensive card right here. Or like our other two options is to have an expensive card against blue or tensions between white. If white wants to hold that for whatever reason, white just made a play to try to grab some territory back and take a cap. So I don't know. I'm just going to try to be, not super aggressive towards white. And then blue's going to break them anyway. Okay, cool. This late in the game, the bonuses aren't everything. Obviously, it's 200 plus for the sets. But if I can be friendly towards the players, then I will. Green starting with 13. Green's down in the Orient. Yeah, green just taking a card and passing. Red has over 800 now on their cap. How many times you attack? They might be killing blue. They're attacking. No, they don't. Okay. Okay. Blue dies, then green, then white. No, probably it's probably blue, then white, then green, and then a 1v1 between me and the red player. If I set, blue's got three cards, that would put me on four, and then what? And then what? I'm really thinking about my turn here, guys. I don't want to smoke that 76, but it would be nice to just have 100 on that cap just to take it before red can.
Oh, God, what do I do here?
Obviously, there's multiple ways to play the same scenario, so... But I think right now, the better play is to have a big stack to be able to make a kill. Taking a cap can happen later on, it's fine. It's not a good idea to try to push through a 76 with how strong Red's cap is. Red still has a bigger cap than me. They were at about an 800 cap before, and then they just set with a 200. They attacked twice, they put it back on their cap. Yeah, I don't know. Have you ever beaten Pete? No, I actually haven't had the chance to play against Pete just yet. Not just yet, but speaking of Pete, Pete and I are posting YouTube shorts now. So if you look on the channel RoboRisk on YouTube, saying this for mostly the Twitch peeps over there, but at RoboRisk on YouTube, Pete and I are posting YouTube shorts. We have every Saturday and Sunday shorts going up. And then I'm also talking to some other creators. Kilted and I were going to be recording some shorts, and then I need to reach out to even more creators. It's just I haven't had the chance to really get to know a lot of them. And Pete and Kilted are just two that I, you know, have watched for a longer time and have talked to more. That's really the only reason why, but I, you know, I'd love to record with whoever, you know. But I just got to get to know people and stuff. But yeah, so we got shorts coming up, and then yeah, I would love to play against Pete. And, I mean, dude, I'd love to play against any of the top dogs, you know? Just for fun, if anything. But, yeah, I saw those shorts there. Great. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate that, Corpse Hero. Did Red just laugh? Yeah, I've got some really funny ideas for Kilted. I mean, Pete's Risk GeoGuessr shorts make so much sense. Because if you guys watch Pete's live streams, before he plays Risk on Twitch... He'll go and he'll play GeoGuessr. He's actually pretty good. He's way better than me at it. So it's kind of a funny idea. Risk GeoGuessr. Zoom in on one of the maps and have Pete try to figure out. Is he card blocking Red? You know, that's kind of what I was wondering too, because Green had over 400 on that stack and they moved up. And now they have 376. So I think you might be right. He did, LOL. Yeah, I think you're right, Reko. Or Reko? I hope I'm saying that right. Yeah, I'm gonna say thumbs up to that. Yeah, you can, White, dude, White and I have had beef the whole game. Dude, White, you realize that the sets are for 220. I took a card right here on you. You had like a 3, and now you're mad that I broke your plus 4 in Southern Europe. Come on, White. Oh, geez, White. What am I going to do with you, man? What am I going to do with you? Okay, now Red's going to push through and they have beef with Green. I could kill White. I don't know why White's mad at me. White's got like a 400 right here. So we're gonna do it like this. If you want to push through and break my bonus, I'm gonna... Yeah, whatever. Deck, hey bro, you have the wrong game. Hearts of Iron instead of Risk, really? Under stream, really? I didn't even know I could do that. On YouTube? What? Dude, thank you so much for letting me know, Deck. Yo, shout out to Deck, by the way, in the YouTube chat. Best thumbnail guy in the game. Absolutely goated thumbnails from Deck. Okay, whoa. Oh yeah, he's right. What? How does that even happen? Hold on one second, guys. Yo, thanks for letting me know, man. What in the world? Let me see. Show more. Oh, no, it shows I don't have anything on my end. It shows I didn't even select a game. Hearts of Iron. Hold on. Risk. Okay, see if that changed. I hope you're talking about YouTube instead of Twitch, because on Twitch it shows the right thing, and on YouTube on my end, it just shows I'm not saying that it's a game. Let's see. Rico, wow, blown 5 cards, spicy time. You are exactly right, my friend. I think it's time for Blue to die. I don't have a set, but I will, obviously, if I get those 5 cards. And then maybe that would give me a back-to-back set. Because then I would take a card, which... Yeah, and then I grab those 5 cards. So, yeah, I think I would be in really, really good shape if I kill blue right here. You fixed it? Yeah, I don't know, man. I will say, though, that on live streaming on YouTube, there are a lot of really weird glitches. Like, sometimes I'll set a thumbnail, and I will set it perfectly. I've done it a million times. Set the thumbnail, save... leave, and then I come back and there's no thumbnail. So there's some weird glitches, but I don't know. Thank you for letting me know, though, because on my end, it looked like it was totally fine. But okay, I'm glad we got that fixed, my friend. I'm glad we got that fixed. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I think you're going to go for the blue kill. I'm going to say well played. Yeah, look at how much they're attacking. They're going to get it. That's 5 cards. They have 600 now. That's going to give them 200 extra... By the way, I know it looks weird when I drink from this, but it is in a wallet, folks. So there is a straw. You kind of can't see it. It's a part of the mouthpiece. Absolutely goated. And you do not kill blue. Does white kill blue? Yeah. White had the kill guard, I guess. Okay, now do I completely taste all these troops that you're about to draft? You put 200 down here and just... Yeah... I think white's going to shove that up our back door over here, probably. Who laughed at that? Was that green? That's a well played. That had to be a kill guard, right? A single attack. And then they get blue. Had to be. Yeah! 64. Yeah! Okay. So, now this is important for us to remember that white is probably a lower skilled player. Because I broke a +4 when they didn't even have a serious guard. And they weren't even holding it for very long. And they got upset about it when the sets are for 200. So I actually think I'll go to war with white now, probably. Let's just take a card up here for now. Green took that cap. I think I want to open up red to do something. Wait, what? Why do you want to fist bump me now? You guys, why, dude? Dude, bro. Okay, you're opened up. Go do something, Red. Go be crazy. Dude, what is the white player's logic, man? Like, oh my god. Okay, look, white. Look, I'll fist bump you back. Me and White's relationship this game has been so funny. 4-player endgame. Green doing a lot of attacking into red or white. Probably red. Yeah, red starting with 6. Okay, so we do predict that right. So tensions between green and red. Green sets when I open up their big stack. What do you do with it, red? That was the perfect time to open up red's big stack right before they get a set. Now, if I am going to try to deal with white, this is the time to do it. When green and red are at war, okay? Now, there's two different ways that we can play this go, though. I can try to either help red with green. Wow, so green came around and broke that. That's crazy. But yeah, red's just taking it back and trying to ease the tensions. Red showing signs of being a good player, by the way. Where do you take a card, white? Not on me? Okay, so you take it into green. Green is starting with way more than everybody. After that turn, I mean, I'm imagining. And then leader is 2 out of 6, so we have green holding 2, and we have red holding 2, right? I need to go looking at the board. And then you back up. I'm going to say thanks. I'm not going to set just yet. I have a free card down here. Okay, so me and white come to an understanding. It only took throwing my 800 stack in their face, and they're like, maybe I should fist bump this guy. And then they back out of my West Africa. So that's nice. We get a cheeky +6 back, even though it doesn't really matter. But and it's really nice that I'm able to kind of hold the whole bottom left side of the board. It forces a lot of tensions to happen to the north, since there's only two ways in, right? You got to go up through the noob corner or push in through the Alps, which white has kind of grabbed. So there's going to be a lot of tensions on the noob corner. And if there's not tensions on the noob corner, then it's tensions between white and green, right? And a potentially red, depending on who ended up with this cap over here. Wow, we do see green down here. And green is leaving me alone. Okay, good. So green being in Russia and me being over here on the left side has proven to be beneficial for me, because green has had tensions with all the other players and not us. So he was really tough until he realized your whole stack could hit him. Yeah. Oh, dude. The saga, the character arc of the white player has been beautiful to watch this game. It's been so much fun. White just gets extremely angry, and then we figure it out. And then I do something that makes white extremely angry, and then we figure it out. He's just a loose cannon. White definitely is not going to win this game. There's no way. That 64 moved out quick. Yeah. Yep. You are exactly right. Now, and also notice, this is extremely, extremely bad for the green player, because guess what? Green's fighting a war on two fronts. Green comes down here and goes looking, pisses off the white player. White says, good luck. That was at green, right? Meanwhile, green is fighting red as well. This is very bad for green. My predictions now change to green going out first. Now look, white's going to come down here, clear out green, and I'm going to predict them to stop right here at my 3, and then now they're going to push east. Yeah, they only see that 8 down there. They stop there. Now this is them pushing out east. Dealing with green. Meanwhile, red is also dealing with green up here on the north side of the board, also pushing out east. This is very bad for green. I'm going to be very interested to see what green starts with on their on the following turn. Red starting with 7, white starting with 17. I am definitely in a winning position here, guys. Definitely. Blackberry Bonkers wearing the bucket hat, coming in clutch for the boys. Started with 22. Look at us, folks. Who would have thought? Not me. Ooh, we have a 1,000 stack, folks. Somebody is going to die. Free card. Open up red. Okay, red stack is open. If red is a good player, they will not... Oh, dude, see, okay, so my predictions about red are actually beginning to change, because I've noticed every single time I do that, red just closes it. Like, red, you do not understand that you're trying to take a +3. You're trying to get a +3 instead of understanding the value that comes with having your big stack open on the main highway. Dude, burgundy, being able to push through with your stack is huge for taking a kill. It's everything. Because white's always taking the Dinaric Alps, so you're always going to be able to push through and have access into both white and green. But instead, watch, when it gets to red's turn, what he's going to do, he's just going to take that one. It's ridiculous. Red definitely, definitely not showing signs of being a good player. If I can get, see, and then look at this. Look at white also blocking with their eights. I don't know, man. My opinion of these players is beginning to change a little bit. I think there is potential for any of them to be the master rank. But I wouldn't be surprised if any of them were, like, expert. What we need to do is take advantage of the wars that are happening and the Cold Wars. And try to chain a kill, use our thousand stack, let it get opened up, and then boo bop somebody when we can verify that we can get the kill. We need to go looking around the board and get an update on where all the caps are at, and then make a play the next time our stack gets opened. Which, considering the highway that we border right here, it should be opened pretty easily. I'm always going to leave that as a one. I'm not going to show anybody. See, and then look at this. Yeah, red's definitely not a grandmaster. Probably not even a master. I'm going to be honest with you guys. That is such an awful play. Red just gave up all of the mobility on their cap in exchange for a plus three. One of the worst plays you could possibly make at this stage of the game. Especially on round 31. There's no, dude, that is an unacceptable play. And then now here's the difficult part that I have. Now me continuing to do that is going to show as a sign of aggression to the red player when in reality it's not. Maybe green still has a card block there. That's a good point. It is possible that, but I mean, green didn't have a lot of cards, or green didn't have a lot going on over there anyway. Like, they had a 400 and then they moved and then they had a 370. I don't know. I would be surprised if that were the case. I need to go looking. I need this stack to get opened up. I think I want to piss off white. You're right. After I said that, red ended up attacking like five or six times. Yeah. See, white's mad at this. I'm just going looking though. That was a bit of a sporadic look. But I just, at the last second, didn't want to continue attacking into white. So I just kept going a little bit further, just that way white didn't take it as too much of a sign of aggression. Green player very slow, by the way. Something to take note of. Maybe touch controls, maybe mobile, based on that speed. That's a pretty common speed I've seen with players that are on mobile. So green would be a really good person to go into the 1v1 with. I'm going to write that down. Green equals 1v1. Yep, that's just a good thing to remember. I always, as I play, guys, I like to keep notes off to the side. I keep notes of where the caps are at and just any other useful information that might be good for me, to where late game I can just glance and just see where my head was at. But with green being on the opposite side of the board, I'm not going to always have that reminder of how slow they are. So I'm just taking a moment to write that down. Let's see how white reacts to us doing that, as white was thinking at us. Those blizzards, yo, Ian Tiger, NPC, damn, dude, these blizzards are bonkers. I mean, dude, you have to kind of push through burgundy. Like, it's just insane. Yeah, these blizzards are absolutely insane. Okay, now what does white do here? Does white choose to break us? Do they take it as a sign of aggression? It may just be time for me to go to war with white. I could actually kill white, by the way. It's like a one-point hold crazy. Yeah, that one-point hold splits the map. Okay, so white is just taking their territory back. I'm thinking that white has this down here now, based on how they're behaving. I am going to... The next time somebody opens up my cap, I kill white, I think. I think that's what I want to do. Dude trade. Not time. Not time to trade just yet. I want to go down here looking at what's going on with white. And then what else? What else? What else do I want to do here? I'm going to leave my cap alone. Sorry, guys. I'm taking a while. I'm just trying to think about what the best play is. Yeah, so white has that. That's enough for me to understand what's going on there. And then I'm going to do this. I'm going to put this somewhere where nobody can... whatever. Okay, so green is slow. White is down there. So I'm gonna write this down real quick. Let's go ahead and readjust. Because right now my notes still say white Vienna, purple Istanbul, green Netherlands, or blue Netherlands, sorry. Green Kharkiv and red in Mercia. So let's change some of this down. So we have white in Vienna and they are now in Istanbul. where purple originally was. Okay, so White's in Vienna and the Orient, and then let's go ahead and just remove purple from our notes here. Blue is not in the Netherlands anymore. That is now green. So green is in Kharkiv and the Netherlands. Yep. And then now we have red in Mercia, and then obviously, so red and I are the two that have one cap. Is white cap in Italy? So white is over here in Vienna. Hard to know how many white has on the Orient cap. Probably 300. Yeah, at least 300. Yeah, that's true. I need to go looking at it. I think on my next turn, I'll just go down here and go looking. It's, you know, white's going to see it as an aggressive move, but I just need an update on that. And Istanbul, right? Yeah, so white is Istanbul and Vienna, correct. Okay, now green has an 800 and a 400. Red's cap is very strong. Red has a really strong cap. I'm beginning to kind of regret not taking the blue cap earlier when it was being guarded. Okay, that goes back onto your cap. I want to go look at your Istanbul cap. I have the set here. We get the dude trade. And then, let's think about this. I am going to... make that a 1300. Oh, by the way, hold on, guys. I got a new mouse. I haven't showed you guys. Check it out. Now I can move a bunch of troops at lightning speed. Check that out, dude. Look at that down there. Oh, my goodness. Look at me go. Look at me go, folks. So, yeah. We finally did do that. But, yeah, I'm just going to put... I'm going to make this a cheeky 130. You have a 700. Now I'm going to go... Oh, wow. And then I'm going to say... Oops. Leave that 100 over there. What mouse do you have? It is... Oh. This one, it is the Logitech G502 Lightspeed. It's that one. Logitech G502 Lightspeed. It's really cool. I had the Logitech Pro for a while, which is this one right here. Logitech Pro. Oh, you can't see it. Logitech Pro is another really, really good mouse. I think that the Logitech Lightspeed G502 is better, though, for, you know, I don't know, games like Valorant or, you know, FPS games, because there are a million side buttons. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, technically 6 additional buttons, which is really good for those games like Valorant or, you know, Fortnite, you know, building walls and stuff, and... really, really good for games like that. But I mean, the primary reason that I got it was because the Logitech Pro, which is another, like, one of the most popular mouses, does not have the ability to unlock the scroll wheel and do infinite scroll wheel. And even more so, do you smack that, White? No, you go over there. You're going to try to remove me, but I have a 100. Yeah. Why was going up there to remove me from the pocket? I have a 100. But yeah, dude, I couldn't even find like a mod to mod my Logitech Pro, and I loved that mouse. It's like a $100 mouse, and so I had to just get the freaking the Lightspeed. It is what it is, folks. Okay, so I think I just take a card up here on this one, and then we chill. Logitech G502 Lightspeed, got it. Yep, it's a great mouse, man. I highly recommend it, especially for Risk. But obviously, you know, there's a lot of other use cases depending on the other games that you play. So, me, I'm a variety gamer. Speaking of which, you guys can check out my other channel, Level Up Robo, where I play a bunch of other games, man. I play Nintendo games. I play first-person shooter games. We are a gamer over here. But, so yeah, this mouse will come in handy for that. For sure. But yeah, having a lot of fun on Risk lately, man. I've been really enjoying it. And then we also have the Risk World Championships coming up here. So don't forget to sign up if you guys are just watching this back. March 4th is the soft deadline, I believe. And then March 8th or March 10th is the hard deadline to sign up. Just go to the Risk Discord. Whenever you're at the homepage in the game, Risk, in the bottom left-hand corner, there's a button for Discord that'll take you there if you haven't joined. And then you can find, you know, ask around in there where to sign up, but they have, you know, chats showing you how to do that over there. Does it have hyperspeed or infinite scroll? So it has infinite scroll. So basically there's a button that this mouse has that's right below the scroll wheel. You press it and now it's unlocked. And it'll just scroll forever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever. So, and then you can press it again. And then it locks it to where now it just... one scroll is like one tick, right? Which is really good for certain games as well. So that's one of the reasons why I like it. Is because the actual mod for... mod is the wrong word. It comes stock like that. But the actual way that you unlock the scroll wheel is really nice. So, yep, really good mouse for sure, for sure. Okay, let's see. And then you do that. What is our set? We have a... Okay, nice. Dan, that'll cost a lot then. Yeah, it's not the best mouse as far as, like, cost. Definitely not. Definitely not. It is... Let me see. How much is it right now? If you were to just go to, like, Amazon... Logitech. What is the name of it? I just got it. I forget the name so fast. G502 Lightspeed. It is, yeah, like $120. It's an expensive mouse, guys. It's an expensive mouse. You could find a cheaper mouse that has the scroll wheel unlocked for sure. How are your animations so fast? So basically, if you want to have fast anime, hold on, wait, 1 second, guys. Red was doing a lot of attacking there. Whoa! Whoa! Where are you going? Okay, you're not going south. Oh my goodness. The tension snaps, folks. It snaps right in half. Wow. Okay. Oh my goodness. So that was specifically into green. White still starts with a ton. Green being very passive and letting white hold a large part of the board. Oh my goodness gracious. Let's see. So Tanada. Here are my settings. Or actually, I don't know if you can see it. So camera animations are off. Let's see, face change animations off, end phase confirmation off. And then what I do is I'm on PC, so it's click, enter, enter, click, enter, enter, click. That's how you attack really quickly. I hope that answers your question. Let's see, good luck with this stalemate. I like your style and hope to catch you again. I'll look for your YouTube. Yeah, Rico, I'm on YouTube, just at RoboRisk. So we're posting daily Risk videos. Okay, so. Let's see. Leaz, are you still playing? Absolutely. I absolutely am. Okay, so I have to set here, folks. I really want to go looking at Red's cap and see what's going on. I'm going to leave that alone up there. Red's on two cards, though, so it's not time to kill them just yet. I think I actually do want to take this cap. Let's just take a cheeky look. Whoa! Wait a second here, folks. Wait a second. No, I fuck it up. Oh, God. Messing with my mouse settings like an idiot. I'm still getting used to the scroll wheel, guys. I'm sorry. Okay, it's fine. So Red might have pulled another cap, though. Red had too many troops for them to be that weak, but it's interesting that White took that cap. But that's just a good opportunity to just grab that cap. If somebody wants to grab it back, they have to go through 100 troops. It wasn't time to kill Red anyway. I did really want to go looking. Oh, wait, right, yeah, Red doesn't have a cap. So Red just fucks it up, and they have a ton of troops somewhere else on the board. They just have a ton of troops. So yeah, maybe I could have got that kill, but I think that even if I did find Red, and let's just say they had like, I don't know, like 500 troops, I wouldn't have done it anyway. They're just on two cards. So it's coming up here really soon, though. Red's going to have to die, I think. White has three caps now, right? Yeah, White has three. So they have Vienna, Istanbul, and Red's cap up here. Doesn't green have three caps? No, green is too slow, and green just sits right here. Now, this is going to set white again. And let's see what white chooses to do here. Red's saying good game, so I think that they're implying that white is killing them. Yes. And then I'm going to say, well played. Now they want to come looking at that cap. And they might try to smack it right here. Let's see if they just try to beef it up, though. I would much rather go into a 1v1 with a green player. That's what sucks. You're going to try to come look at this cap now. I'm going to say thanks. Okay, you lock your stack. So we have 190 right there. And then white's leaving our big stack locked. And you're leaving a 68 right there in my face. That's pretty interesting. I need to show good faith to white. Green doesn't have any troops for me to attack. That's the issue. Oh, gosh. I think it's time for me to break white now. I think it's time for me to break white. Hold on, guys. Hold on. I think I have to. You're holding... you're just holding so much of the board. I think I have to. You're not opening up my big stack. So I just need to make that just annoying enough to hit. Since white is choosing not to open up my big stack, that's the play there. Okay, let's see. Is this a faster version with more troops or just a normal game that is late in the rounds? It's Tanada. This is progressive cards. That's what it is. So that's why there's more troops. So in progressive cards, every time you set, the sets get higher. So you can see our next set will be 295, then 300, then 305. And whenever you're on round 38, that's just kind of how it looks. Let's see. Just out of interest, hi, by the way, if I was green, I just hit the big stack there. Is that the wrong play? Yeah, green could hit that big stack, and that's fine if they choose to do that. But it's not, you know, no sweat off my back if they choose to do that. But green is being very passive, so I don't predict them to do that with how they're playing. White moves off of our... Green is just kind of taking a card and passing, which is very interesting here. We're going to put that right there. We'll set next turn. I need to go looking at white's caps. You got a 900, you have a 500, and then a 300. Let's see if white laughs at that. Okay, so here we go. Now we have white up in Mercia, Vienna, Istanbul. Okay, we have green in Kharkiv. Green's taking a card and passing. Green is not going to help me at all with white. So this is a huge issue for me. White starting with what? White starting with 38. So I have a choice to make here, guys. I have a choice to make here. I'm starting with 27. $900, $400. You have like 300 up here. Green just has 900. White's gonna have a set next turn. It's not time yet. Right before white sets, I don't attack white. Oh, I get a wild. Oh, that's huge. I never use that wild ever in my life. Never, ever in my life. I'll set on 5 cards and try to hold the wild. Okay, so notice right before white sets, I attack green's 4. Let's see what green wants to do here. Yeah, green just take a card, passes my prediction. If you're going to win, you're going to have to hit the troops anyway. Might as well do it whilst you have attacker's advantage. It just depends, you know, there's so many different ways to play the same scenario. Based on Yeah, no, based on, sorry, I'm reading chat and trying to talk at the exact same time. Based on how these players are playing is why I'm playing it the way I am. You know, in another scenario, that's probably the wrong play. In this scenario, I think it's okay. It's okay. But I'm just trying to hold... I mean, the original thought process behind having the 100 over there anyway was back whenever... was back when I was trying to have an exterior position. Now, here's what I think I want to do. White set... No! All right, let's open up your big stack. And then let's let white come out and be crazy. And then what I'm doing now is I'm just going to bring that out over here. Now, white can't see that. And then so now they'll probably open that stack. And then I'm just going to attack. I'm going to roll that cap. And then white and I can go to war. If I end up going into a 1v1 with green, I'm actually totally fine with that. Green is so slow. I'm going to fist bump green. I'm going to try to be friendly to green now. Green is going to continue attacking and not into me. So this is my win condition here. White's trying to hold three caps. I just need to pluck one of white's caps. And I'm going to pluck this one. And then it's going to force all the tension between white and green. And then I'm just going to, you know, move troops over here to try to work on a card block, right? Green is just so slow. Oh, green. I would love to be in a 1v1 with green. Green's going looking. Yeah, green wants to see that cap. Green's a little bit faster than I was giving them credit for, actually. Not fast enough to take the whole board in a single turn, though. There's no way. Like, I would take the whole board, and then I would have to hope that green doesn't... Okay, do you open me? I need one of my stacks open, and I'm just going to boobop the white. That white. No, they're not going to do it, though. They're not going to open either of my stacks, and that's other reason for me to want to come down? No, you don't. Yeah, you don't. Okay, well, then I'm just going to grab this other bonus. I would have to burn my wild to set, so never in my wildest dreams would I ever do that. Let's just do this. That's my bonus now. And then I don't attack green. I really need this to get opened up right here to let my big stack out. And then I'll really slap white. Nice, you attack white. See, that's kind of the psychology aspect of this game, right? I come out to attack and I don't even hit this. It would have been so easy for me to hit this green one, but I didn't, right? Okay, and that's really green's only stack is just 1,000, just a single cap. What do you do? Put it there and then open up my stack. Because I have a set next turn, no matter what you bring back, I'm just going to smack it. Can I get away with not using my wild here? No, I have to use my wild. No. Why does that always happen when I get a wild card? Okay, so now white's going to go and try to break me down there. That's fine. I'm actually going to work in like a little bit of a card block down there, I think. And just hold right here on Rome. Or actually, no, I'm going to hold here on Sardinia to ensure that I continue having cards. White doing this right before I have a set's not really like the smartest idea. I'm going to go clear all that out and then leave a stack on Sardinia. And take this cap at the same time, I think. See, and then they don't open me. This is showing tendencies of a very good player. God, I have to burn my wild. That's so annoying. I hate that. I have 300 to burn. So here's what we do. This will be a card block down here. I need a little over 100. 125 should be fine. And then you don't open up my stack ever. I need green to open up my stack. I really need green to open up my stack. Okay, it's fine. For now, this is okay. Let's, Now we sit there. Hey, green sets. I leave an 8 there, which is really annoying. Sorry. Ugh. You hit my 3 weird. Yes! Thank you! 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 Okay, now white needs to push through my 8. Okay, now I'm gonna smack white and I'm gonna take this cap. Yep. Hit that 8, baby! Oh, your cap's dead. Oh my goodness, you love to see it, folks. Your cap is so, so dead. Okay. And then we do this. So, this... Okay, I know exactly what I'm gonna do. And then you're gonna be on 3 cards? Oh my god, I know exactly what I'm gonna do here. So we're gonna do this. What is your cap? Yeah, I'm gonna smack that for sure. 1,000,000%, I smack that. Okay, now white is forced to deal with green. And then we do it like this. I don't know why white's laughing. That's the right play for sure. That is 1,000,000% the right play. And then I still have my big stack too, which they're never going to open up. So if somebody wants to come through and smack that, then we're chilling. And then now green should go into white, and now I'm going to fist bump green. I'm going to say, well played. Well played. Yes. Okay, so green and I are coming to an understanding. And now white's laughing, dude. White's fucked. White is so screwed. Nice. This is great. White's starting with 10. White doesn't have a set. Their big stack got opened up, though. White may come over here and smack my stack because of green coming through. Having this 30 here is actually pretty stupid. I need to move this back onto one of my other caps. So I'm going to do this. It's not time to set yet. Actually, do I want to? No, I'd have to. Oh, I got a... Well, no. Well, 300. White's going to have a set. No, it is the time. It's the time. I don't like ever setting on 4 or 3. But now is the time because white's potentially going to have a set. And they may come through like a loose cannon. Now I'm going to fortify that back. So here's what I'm going to do. That's my card down here. That's to help work in the card block. Pop, pop. Leave that as a 30. If white wants to try to smoke that, that's okay. White is most likely to smack this. And then I can make this. Yeah. Okay, cool. Okay, pop, pop. And then over here. Okay, and then I fortify this up here. Yes. Okay. That's how you do that. That's how you get use out of that. And then I don't want to have a 30 there anyway because I want my big stack to get opened up. Yeah. Attack right there, please. 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 Oh, he's not going to do it. Thanks. Yes, thanks. Okay, cool. Nice. Okay, so green and I are homies. Green and I are homies. That's ideal, too, to go into the 1v1 with green. Okay, now you have 300. You have a big stack. You're going to smack one of my things, but setting there is the right call because now they're going to burn a lot more troops. Okay, so what do you do? Yeah, you don't do it. See, and that's why I strengthen that. If I had 100 there, you'd probably smack it. And now I'm opened, which is great. Now I actually never want to open. I never want to close this off ever again either. I'm going to try to take cards somewhere else now. Because now, look at this. I have movement for all my caps. How sick is that, guys? Oh my goodness. All of my caps have movement. This is incredible. This is incredible. Okay, we are in a really, really good position now. Holy cow. We are in such a good position. Oh my goodness. We are in such a good position, guys. This is for sure a winning position. White had a 900 here. What they were coming off of there was their Vienna cat. That's what we were seeing there. Yep. This game is shaping up to be a bit of a banger. We're at about 2 hours. This has been a long one, guys. This is a really long game. This is a good game, though. I've been having a lot of fun with this game. Green being on one stack is proving to be useful for them. I need green to make the next move. I took one of the white caps. It's green's responsibility now to take the other one. Okay, we see white. Okay, your boy's getting 38 per turn. How do we squeeze off the white player? How do we do it? I think I want to open up white's cap this way into green. So I am actually going to go looking and make that a 13, which is like really all I need. Now green can see that I'm attacking white. Okay, so you have a 12 and a 960. Okay. White says thanks. See, white is showing signs of being a good player. They understand the benefit of that. No, leave that one there. No, dang it. Okay, so now that white's being opened up, green opens them up to come over here now. That's so annoying. That was my thought process behind taking a moment to do that, was because they wouldn't be able to come up here and come around, and then they were locked off over here on burgundy anyway. So any aggression that they had from their big stack had to go into green. So now the aggression, it opens up the possibility for the aggression to come into me, which is really unfortunate. Okay, you probably smack my cap here. And then I'm just gonna smack it back. Okay. Got it. I don't set just yet. There's no point. Here's what I do now. I'm just gonna trail back. Oh my goodness, wait, I just realized, guys. That might be the thumbnail. Look at this. Do I want to leave that 11 there? It's kind of doing nothing for me. Nah, I'll leave it there. Whatever. It's kind of funny. You guys, look at this thumbnail. Wait a second. Oh my goodness. What a thumbnail. Wow. We have the whole left side of the board taking advantage of those blizzards that are cut in half. My goodness gracious. What a game, folks. These blizzards are bananas. Green ain't slow, I can tell you that for sure. Yeah. Man, I'm so back and forth on how I feel about these players. Real. I am so back and forth about it. I put the dudes, that way I put the three dudes back into the deck, and then maybe I can get a back-to-back trade after this turn. White's gonna have a set now. I don't want to open up your stacks now that you have a set. But you are showing more aggression up here, so I'm just going to make sure that cap's a little bit stronger. Sets are for 350. I don't get a set. I missed that. The green set. Yeah. Sets gets the 345. White's going to set, get the 350. Can you set up a card block? Does green know enough to help? I can try to set up the card block. Yeah, that may be my only way here. My only way to actually squeeze the white player. But I think you're right. I think that's the play that we have to make now. But it sucks because now green has a 2,000 cap. And if I set up the card block, then white's aggression comes into me, right? And if white's going to suicide into somebody, it's going to be me. Green would have to help over here. All right, let's see what white does. Now that white has set, now would be the time to try to set up the card block. You get 350 with none of your caps open. Oh, you're going to burn through down there. Okay. Got to blast through 100. Well, you're not going to get through my 116, so... Okay, and then how much do you leave there? You don't leave anything. So yeah, I believe I am now going to try to set up the card block, but see, I need green to help me, man. And like, this gets really messy because of green's positioning and green is not taking cards. So I don't see how green's going to be able to help me with this card block, which is so frustrating. God, that's so frustrating, man. It's not going to be able to happen this turn, I don't think. You have a three down there. When the world needed him most, the 89, baby. Okay, so the left side of the board is basically card blocked. I need green to help me with the right side. If not, what are my options here? I go off on my 31 on my next set, which is now. I'll go ahead and take it to try to get the card block in before white can get... I would see, but this... Oh, God, I need to hope that white doesn't have a set on four, though, which they... There's a 75 to 80% chance that they do. Wait, is that a card block right there? I think it is. Okay, wait, white sets on three, yes! White sets on three. This is the time. This is the time to try to set a card, to try to work in a card block. I'm gonna set. I put like 100 up here. Oh my God, this is the time to set in a card, this is time to work in a card block. Yeah, this is the time. And white's burning all their troops right now, too, from their sets. Well, they're going to be able to fortify like 200 back onto their main cap. Yep, then you fortify that back. Okay, so yeah, we are going to try to do a card block here, folks. So I need to do this. We're going to go off of our cap, actually. Well, no, here. We'll just do it right here. This is fine. We're going to make this about that. That's going to wrap all the way back around, go through pop, and then sit right over here. Yes. See, I'm not going to be able to get it, I don't think. I need to move this. Ah, dang it. White's still gonna have cards. I have to do it like this. Oh, I gotta go faster. I'm not gonna be able to get it. Oh, no. Hold on. We gotta go. I'm not gonna be able to get it. God dang it. Okay, it's fine. We have the prep set to be able to get the card block on the following turn. Help me, green, help me. See it, believe it, think it, feel it. White's got one more card if green knows how to do this. Yes! I think green sees it. Green sees it. Green sees it. I'm going to say well played. Well played. Green sees it, I think. Oh, well played. Well played, green. Now move your 120, 122 over somewhere else, like over to the Orient or something. White has one more card. That's it. And then they're going to have to move their stack out somewhere. Yep, this is attacking into the Orient. Yes! Green sees it. Oh my goodness. That is such a well played, man. Yep, that's your last card. Good luck. Ooh, is that a bot out? No, it's not. Don't worry, green. I'm going to take care of that. Don't worry. I got us. Okay, now, at this point, this is about to be a very fragile state that the white player is in. I don't emote anymore. No more. I don't emote. I don't interact with the white player because now they're fixing to have to start to move troops off their stack, and they will have to make a decision. Who do they sue? That's the decision that they're going to have to make here. That's good. That's good. Pop, pop. And then now I need to make sure that I can continue getting cards over here on white. So that's good. Now we go up here. Green, what are you doing? I wasn't able to freaking... Okay, whatever. That's fine. Dang it. I'm going to say well played. That's so annoying though, because now I have to do this. Okay, white doesn't have a card. Now green and I need a trading zone. And then also I need to fortify this 123 out. Oh, you gonna go for the white kill? What? Okay, so white doesn't have a card now. Okay, cool. Now we don't say anything. We don't say anything to the white player. Now is not the time. Like, a lot of people would want to just laugh when that happens. It's not the time to do that. White doesn't move any troops out, by the way. Okay, so white's definitely not a grandmaster. There's no way. There's no way that white's a grandmaster. That is when you move the troops out. So here's what we do now. We are going to... Let's just make that... No, we're just going to make both of these 60s. Okay, and then I'm going to take a 3 right there, move that back, and then move my 123 down onto my cap. The rest goes right here. Yep, that's good, that's good, that's good, that's good. Fortify that all the way back onto my cap. Okay. Oh, you take a card on my 1, please? I'm not holding that bonus anyway. I'm happy to make that a trading zone. Yes. Nice. Okay, cool. That's the trading zone now. Nice. Okay. Green and I will trade cards to the north. Do we see a bot out here? Okay, the white player has two options. Bot out or move your stack. Bot out or move your stack. If anybody is between the ranks of novice to expert, this is what I recommend practicing, is the card blocks. See it, feel it, believe it, think it. Okay, so, dude, I swear, if I get a cavalry, I'm going to lose my mind. I can never hold my wilds. And then, yeah, now I take a card up here. I need to strengthen that. Okay, green, trade with me up there. Trade with me up there. Yes, fortify that three back. Thank you. We can trade there every day. Yes. I like this. I'm in a really, really good position where my caps have access to the board, green's does not, and white is card blocked. This is a really good spot for me, guys. I do have a couple critiques to my gameplay for this game, though. I could have worked in the card block sooner, but I just didn't know how green was going to help me. I just didn't see it. But then green helped me. Like, I don't know. I guess I underestimated the green player there. Green started helping me at the perfect time. Oh my gosh, this game has been so crazy. I'm so happy I was able to get a game like this on stream with just these insane blizzards. Dude, no way! Why does this always happen to me, dude? Why? It happens to me way more than it should. Oh. God. That is true pain, bro. Oh, come on, man. Okay, this is my big hitter. I do want to make this a 400, though. You need a lot of troops for a 100% roll in that 400. Green has a 2,000 stack over there, but my three caps, I'm definitely a way harder kill than the green player. By far. It's not even close. I'm also winning troops per turn as well. Green starting with 22. I'm starting with 33. White starting with 12. I don't know, man. White might just be holding out for green and I to do something crazy, but it's not going to happen. You're going to have to move troops out, white. See, white's trying to think. Yeah. And then green leaves that over there. You leave a three over there. I think now's my time to actually move this 37 in, so I'm going to. Yep, that's my best opportunity to do that. When green leaves a three in my bonus, I leave a three in his bonus. Yeah, shout out Wesley and shout out Iridescent Beagle. Well played to both of these players in this three-player endgame. Okay, green sets, then what? Beefing up their cap is like really the only thing they can do, or attack down here into the Orient. Okay, oh no, you just take a card pass down there, fortify that out. Now, here's what comes next. Green and I have to decide who is going to make the first move on white. Who is going to do it? Oh, wait, white was getting cards? From where? I guess in the Orient? Bro, I'm an idiot. What is going on, green? What are you doing? What are you doing, green? What in the world? Well, then in that case, my set has to be very particular. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to make this a 2,000. I don't think white's going to want to mess with me whenever they're fixing the set and they can see that I have a 2,000 right there. That is not the smart thing to do. And then I just need to make sure that these are big enough to where if white does want to sue me, I don't get screwed that bad. Okay, so white's going to have a set, and hopefully it goes into green. Sets are big. 390. I have a retaliatory set if I need it. Who fortified to green? White fortified to green instead of you? Oh, definitely helps when they cooperate with the card block rather than breaking all the time. Dude, and then white just goes into me, man. That's just so unfortunate. Green is giving white cards, and then white is going into me. I think I will begin if white continues getting cards over there. I think I'm going to give anger face at the green player. I'm going to go over there and find it and plug that hole up soon. Right now, actually. I'm going to go do it right now. Because if green is unable to do it, I'm just not interested in playing those games. So I only need about 130 right here. I'm going to put the rest over here, and I'm going to go find that hole, and I'm going to plug it up. Ah, this is going to seem very aggressive to green, though, but I need to wrap around and then plug that hole. God, this is so annoying. Oh, green, why are you doing this to us? We had it all. We had everything we could have ever needed, green. If you can't do it, green, I'm gonna do it. Where's the hole? Where's the hole? Okay, hole's plugged. Problem solved, green. Problem solved. But white is still able to get cards down there. God, green, why are you down there trading with white? Why are you down there? Look at how far green came. Why? Why? What are you doing, green? What are you doing? Ugh. And now that white understands that they have a card block, that we're trying to card block them, they're going to probably use every single turn they have. Oh, green, what are you doing, man? There's still a hole? I don't think so. I don't think there's still a hole. Up here, this is all blocked by caps. This 118, 48, 60, 120 blocks that. White is just over here. That's all. And then white, you get a... Green... Okay, you know what? Here's what we do. God, green, what is wrong with you? I sit right here. I just clear it all out, sit right there. Okay, white's... Oh, God. And then white's just going to smoke that 100. This is so annoying, guys. Okay, now try to get a card white. If green's not going to do it, I will. Oh, but I shouldn't have to. White's just going to set on four and then slam through that cheese. I need green to understand the vision here. Also, can we talk about green's cap? Jeez. But it's still a winning position with the three caps that I have. Yep, white has a set. It's 400. You lose 170. That's pretty nice, actually. White tries to clear up the hole, or the... Yeah. Okay, green, I need you to not fuck this up this time. Oh my god, green. Oh my god. Yep. White is very careful to not... Oh, okay, but you open up my stack over there anyway, so I'm chilling. Can we also just say, can we just give props to the white player for not backing out of the game? Yep. Props to White. So I go all the way around, and then I do it like this. That is plugged. Okay, now I have visibility onto Green's cap, which is good. White's gonna try to push through my 26 and they're gonna fail. Let's see, Zero Winter with a subscription. Thank you so much, Zero Winter. Thank you, my boy. White, this is very bad for you, my friend. My opinion of White, I would say White's a master, if I had to guess. I think that's where I'm going to lock that guess in. White's a master. I would put Green as maybe an expert. Because the fact that that just happened delayed our progress so much. That Green just let that happen on the right side of the board. I mean, come on, man. Zero Winter says, hi. Hey, hope you're doing well today. Playing some Risk, playing some Europe Advanced Progressive Capitals today. Okay, do we see, now we see the bot out, I think. I think White realizes that I'm not going to let it happen. And we see the bot out. Okay, cool. Nice. So this is going to get smoked. So I'm just going to leave that as a 30 for now. Because that's going to get smoked. And then what do I want to do? I just need to take a card up here on green. And then I'm going to begin making sure that green can't roll my big cap. That's what matters in the 1v1. Green's just taking a card and passing. I'm holding a lot of the board. Okay, White. When does the White bot move their big stack out? It's going to happen soon. Props to White for hanging in there as long as they did, by the way. That's not easy. Not easy. Good thing is, it's like the bot goes towards Green. Hopefully. Yeah, hopefully. Because remember, yep. Oh, yes! Yes! Okay, nice. So now I'm going to move one of those 50s out and around. So my card's right here. Now I get a cheeky, now I get another bonus. And then I'm going to move this 50 over here and get cards over here in Green's Russia. Yeah. And then here's what I want to do also. I attack right here to let this Vienna cap go to the right. That's what I do for sure. Yes. Ooh. Wait, that changes things. That probably gets rolled, but I wasn't doing anything with those 50s anyway. Ooh, wait, why just had that? Green takes a look. I'm still signaling to Green that we need to deal with the bot first. We got to deal with the bot first. Oh my god, I didn't know White moved everything onto a single cap. That's crazy. Before they bought it out. That's insane. That's so insane. I always keep this line open right here, where you can see these White troops, always. Where could I hide a cheeky little kill guard on White? Maybe what I do... The bot should open me up right over here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to leave Oh, but the bot can set, which is so annoying. I think what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to attack down here and hide a kill guard on Naples. Oh, that's going to smoke my 92 so hard. Oh, my God. You lose 162. That's fine, you guys. Those were the 50s that were sitting here doing nothing. It's okay. It's not the end of the world. Green doesn't see that either, right? Oh, wait, no. Maybe green did. I don't remember. Okay, so we set. How do I want to do this? No, I want to do all my cavalry. Or no. Yeah, all my cavalry. Put those back into the deck. The bot took the cat back? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, do you mean the... Oh, yeah, this one? The one that we just saw? Yeah, I think so. I would really like to have a cheeky kill guard, but that was my launching point. Here's what I do. Here's what I do, I think. Ah, see, but green. From green? Oh, down here? Oh, no, green's down there. Okay, yeah. Okay, so green's got a 350 and a 500. What do we do here, green? What do we do here? What do we do here? Bot's got one cap. Green's got two. I have three. So green is now in Istanbul. Let me go ahead and update my notes here. And then, yeah, white's just in Vienna. Yeah, at this point in the game, the board's really easy to manage and understand. God, this bot is so annoying, man. That's 400 extra troops we have to go through. Jeez. Hit Vienna with the big cap. Hide the one in London. Oh, yeah. No, yeah. Good point. We can hide that in London. But the thing is, though, is that the mobility on this cap is so important, though. Do you know what I mean? But that's, we have a long ways to go. We have a long ways to go until that becomes relevant. Also, hope you're doing well today, by the way. Larshi, hope you're doing well. I need to get this 100 stack up and out. We got a 93 down there causing problems for me. I think it is time for me to take that cap, though. I think it is. I think I need to. Holding four caps. I'm really trying to think about this here, guys. But if you take Vienna, you still have mobility. Yeah, it is true. It is true. Whatever. I'm gonna end up having to smack a bunch of troops anyway at some point, right? Now, green could swing our big cap, though. That's the only thing. The only thing. Now, I just need to... I just need to clear out on my next set. I am actually going to take a set on four here to clear this whole pocket out. And then strengthen this kill guard right here. And then I think we're chilling. Oh, that free scroll wheel sound? Oh, man. Yeah, that one is really, really nice. We just updated the mouse recently. So, I need green to help me, though, with the bot over here on the right side of the board. You gotta help me, green. Okay, bot weakening themselves over here. I am gonna go ahead and set. You move a 700 down there? Oh my God. Oh no. That is really bad. God. Oh, goodness gracious, guys. That is so, so tragic. I'm gonna move this out to show green that I'm happy to get up and out and around. LOL, bots hate you? Oh my god, is it still a bot? Yeah. Pretty sure. Yep, it is. You have a 4,000. I don't think I want to open. Okay, nice. You lose 85. So green trying to help clear out that bot. That's good. Green's going to take a look. Green takes a look. Green sees all of our caps now. Okay, now green is closed off from us. That's good. They're closed off to go up, and they're closed off to go through. So I don't think I open that up. Because now that's helped me work in a card block on green. I gotta deal with this bot, guys, and then try to work in a card block on green. How many troops do you need to kill a 2k cap? So basically, the way that it works with caps is... So yeah, so Tolbarone says 4k. That is correct. That's for a 100% roll. You can get a good roll. You can get a decent roll with 2.5k of the troops. So, but yeah, you need to... Yeah, two to 2.5 times the troops is a good roll. Three times the troops is a 100% roll. Sorry, my thoughts are all over the place. I've been playing for a while. Always get a loss and sent back to novice, though. Oh, man, that is unfortunate. It's definitely hard. There's definitely a lot of things to work on. My recommendation is to always play settings. You know, grind settings that are, you know, that you're really, really good at. And then just keep going from there. This up here. Okay, so I take a card on the bot. And I back up. I actually have so many suggestions as far as that goes, like how to rank up. Like, you need to find good settings and perfect them. That's number one. The risk meta settings is like a really good recommendation there. Green takes a card on the bot. But there's so many like sub recommendations within that, though. Like, there's so many other things that I recommend people work on. Like, you know, playing in the fog with caps. If you can get good at that, you know, the novice, beginner, expert range, I run into people that are very good at those settings, but there's people that aren't as good. And so if you can get really good at that and understand how to read the battle log and how to work with caps and understand the psychology aspect of risk and work with other players, it can really benefit you a lot. Make sure the settings you play are the ones you really enjoy. Yeah, I would say that that's actually the most important thing. Do you smoke my 299? It's possible. It's actually possible that you would do that. Number one is have fun, for sure. So that splits. That's like a 300 to a 200. Do you hit that? Nope. Ooh, you hit green right there. Green's down there taking a look. Well, that helps me. I think on my next set, I'm going to go and just try to clear that out. How much do you move out? Nah, dang it. Ugh. Do I just do it? God. I might as well. Okay, that's a card block on green. Okay. I am actually going to move. I'm just going to leave that 145 there, whatever. Having green look at it is fine. And then let's move this three down here. Okay, so that is showing good faith to the green player that I'm working with them on the bot. They need to manage this side now. So we might go into the 1v1 here really soon, folks. Why do you lower the troops to 75%? So essentially, the slider, that's another really good thing to consider. Now green, I would say this is a bad play by green, you know, hitting my 100 before we're even done with the bot. Although maybe green is going to deal with the bot right here with their big stack. That may be what we're seeing. Keep attacking. I need you to keep attacking here. No, so that's just aggressive towards me. Like, why would you do that? Why would you do that, green? You got to help me with the bot before you try to be aggressive towards me. But anyways, that's the slider. It's a Tanata. So essentially, if you have, let's just say, 20 troops and you're attacking a 1, you want to lower your slider to be 4 troops instead of using the 20, because that's still a 100% roll using the least amount of troops possible, which means that you should theoretically lose less troops on that roll. That's the thought process behind the slider. I'm actually not a big fan of the slider, to be honest with you guys. I'm really not. But it just gives the players another, it just increases the skill ceiling just a little bit more. Okay, so I'm still getting 40 troops per turn. That's great. Sets are going to be for 500. That's going to get boobopped. I take a card on this 35, unfortunately. Or no, I just shrink my way up with this 100. That's what I do. Only works on balanced blitz, though, because true random is disgusting in rolls. Yes, good point. So on true random, it's just even if you would theoretically have a perfect roll and you have it at 100%, it's still going to say 99%. There's no point with true random. Okay, now I think that green is going to help me now, which is nice. Sorry if you can hear my chair. It's loud. Okay, help me out, green, and then send us into the 1v1. And then I can work a card block in. We're getting to the point now where killing the bot would be worth it. With the sets being this high. So if the bots... the bot will not live to set again, I don't think. It will not. I actually think green's stronger than us right now for this 1v1. Because they have like a 4,000 cap and then a 500 cap. But I know where both of them are, so we should be in good shape. We just have a bunch of 500s, which sucks. I take a card right here, and then back up, I think. No. Okay, again, green sees that. That's showing good faith to the green player. I have two cards. Well, no, I really only just have one card right here because I need that mobility to come out with my big stack. I need to be able to get a card block in on green and guarantee myself more cards. Okay. If green's moving a bunch of troops off their big stack right now, which is my prediction, onto their cap, that's what it looks like is happening. That's actually good. Because green having a 4,000 stack is how they swing my 2K stack. Do you know what I mean? So they might be making things a little bit harder for themselves. See, they're taking a long time to fortify here, so this is good. This is good. I think that's what they're doing. They're just going to have like two 2K stacks, which is great. That's ideal for me, so that way they can't swing my big stack. Hold on 1 second, guys. All right, sorry about that, guys. I'm back. Sorry. Okie dokie. The bot needs to die probably soon. The bot's gonna set and then what? I'm gonna go looking, I think. And just get this 1v1 started. Kind of a bad play here, I think. No, you got a 500 right there, damn it. See, I need green to help me with that. Green, I need you to help me. Green's not gonna do it. Okay, just green taking that bonus. So the bot's gonna set and just go near green, basically. Green, you're gonna have to do it, man. Oh my god, that 30 is gonna get smoked. Okay, bot, let's see it. God. Oh, that's so frustrating. I went through, like, what was it? Over 700 troops down in Africa? And green can't help me get rid of the 700 troops that are over on that side of Europe? Like, what? Yeah, okay. Well, green, that's your responsibility now. I could try to work in a card block to where green has to attack white. That could be what I'd do. Yeah, I think that's what I'll do. I have a couple cards up there to where I still don't open up Kharkiv. That's nice. Okay, green sets. If I take out all these bot troops, green can win the 1v1 for sure. I would lose so many troops. Oh my god. God, these fucking bots, man. These stupid bots. Yeah, I think this is a winning position, guys. I think it's a winning position, but we just have, dude, oh my god. Green, you've got to get rid of this bot, man. You've got to help me with this. You have to. You have a 3,500 stack, and you can see how much lower my caps are. You've got to help me with that, man. Yep, wide sets. And they're just putting it all against Green's big cap. What can I do here to show Green? Ugh, dude, see, but I've already worked with Green enough. But now that the bot has set again up there, Green does have to go through more troops than I had to go through down in Africa. So maybe at this point, I can just shoot a bunch of troops into one of the bot's stacks where Green can see it to show Green that I'm happy to help. That's like... Oh, God. Green's not opening up this anymore either, but that's okay. Whenever it comes time for the card block, I'll be able to work it in just fine. I mean, if Green doesn't plan on ever opening that up again, then what I'll do is I'll use my 100, send all that through, and then fortify using my big stack out. So it'll be okay. Either way, we do this, it'll be okay. Oh, goodness gracious, Green. What am I going to do with you, man? Okay, there's the set. No, help me with the bot, you idiot. You're so stupid. Help me with the bot first. Oh, man. This is not how you play these scenarios, man. This is not how you do it. That's not how you play that, man. I would never, ever, ever play it like that, dude. I don't have a set on 4, but that's fine. I have a bunch of options for cards anyway. At this point, I would rather give the bot second LMAO. Yeah. Yeah. I think you're right, man. I think you're right. But see, it's tough, though, because Green has such a big cap. It's a huge problem for me. But no, yeah, I'm gonna smoke the 347 on my next turn or my next set. Like, it makes no sense for Green to do that. I mean, what? What a stupid play. Okay, White's up there. That's a problem for me now. That sucks. That's gonna get broken eventually. Pretty soon, actually. Yeah. Yep, that sucks. That's okay. Ay, ay, ay. So dumb. How much do you fortify up? Nothing. Okay, cool. Good luck. This is exactly how a lot of Masters and Grandmasters play. Hit the players, ignore the bot. No, yeah, it's true. They do. I disagree with the play style, but again, there's so many different ways to play the same scenario. So, you know, it just depends on who you're playing against. Like, I prefer to deal with the bot first and then deal with it afterwards, or deal with the players afterwards. I mean... Yeah, it just depends, man. Personal preference, you know? I wouldn't say that there's a right or wrong way to play, just whatever works for you. But I do feel like in this situation, this is very stupid. I will set and I'll deal with the north side of the bot soon. If you open me up, even better. No, the bot's not going to open up my 600. That's okay, though. Really depends if you're aggressive or a passive player. Yeah, for sure. Also, Zevelzor over on Twitch. Let it be a problem for Green. Welcome to the jet. Welcome to the jet. Hope you're doing well today. Yep, we're just going to do trade here. God. Hmm. Oh, wait, I want these cards. Shit, I shouldn't have taken that. And then now look where we are, Green. Look where we are. We're back where we started. We're right back where we started. Jesus, Green. Okay. Now I have two cards there guaranteed. I should have stopped right here on Yiel. Because Green having a plus four when the sets are freaking 500 is irrelevant. At that point, it's more important for me to have cards. Ooh, thank you for opening that. Thank you for opening that up. I actually really appreciate that. Nice. I had myself blocked in from that. I never take that again now. Green wanted the North Africa bonus. Yeah. Let's see. Why you take those? Aren't those future cards? Yeah, I goofed. Okay. So now, and do I have a 7th round? I don't think so. Ooh. I think I actually am going to YOLO that and just take that set on 3. Yo, the Pete-man in the chat. What's up, Pete? Hope you're doing well today, my boy. Hope you're doing well today. All right, you guys. I typically don't take sets on 3, but I do just want to help squeeze the bot in. The bot's going to have a set. Pete, it's good to see you, my man. Also, guys, as a reminder, we have shorts going up with the Kill Pete strategy today at 5 p.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. We're posting YouTube shorts now. And the Pete-man is being featured. We got some more Risk GeoGuessr for you guys. Those shorts are a ton of fun, man. It was really awesome recording with Pete. Shout out to Pete. We got Sensei Pete in the house. Okay. And then now I'm gonna leave that up there, I think. And I think that's fine for now. It was fun. Yes, man. Absolutely. Bunch of fun. Also, I'm also talking to some other Risk content creators. I'm talking to Kilted a little bit, and then I need to just reach out to more and, you know, talk to some others and see if they want to do some stuff too. So I'd love to collab. We have a bunch of really cool Risk content creators. So. Okay. Yep. The whitebot sets, and then it might actually go against my 645 here. Yeah, darn, that sucks. Okay, that's fine, though. 53. That's not the end of the world. And then everything else should go over here stacking up against the green player's 3,500. Nice. So we don't really see a whole lot of that set. That's great. We see 50 troops. Green's got to help me out, though. Green has got to help me out. When it gets to Green's turn, I'm going to fist bump again. I'm really trying to show the green player that I want to work... You know, deal with this bot before we do anything else. Let's keep that strong. Take here, fortify that back. Bot will hit that and split. Azir Winter, might as well give a follow here too. Oh yeah, you were over on the YouTube chat. Now you're over here on Twitch. Yo, I appreciate that, man. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you, Azir Winter, for the follow. Thank you. Yes, we are multi-streaming here, folks, on YouTube and Twitch. I might start streaming on TikTok. I don't know. I've looked into that a little bit. It says I do meet the qualifications to do it, so maybe I do. And then also, maybe Kick. I don't know. I've actually never made a Kick account, so, but if I can do it, I might as well, right? So, we'll see. But for sure, YouTube and Twitch. For sure. And then I might actually, you know... I think I might start streaming on Twitch a lot more than YouTube as well. Because on YouTube, the thing about it is that, like, you have to make a thumbnail, and it's, like, this whole thing, and, like, I'm particular about the quality, right? And so, I might just start streaming more on Twitch, and then try to conserve the bangers for YouTube. But yeah, okay, so I'm gonna do it like this. I have an easy card over here, and that doesn't open up Green's cap anyway. And then I have the white bot stacking against here, so that becomes a priority for me. Let's do that, and then fortify This three all the way back yonder. Next time the bot sets, that 240 might get slapped, boobopped. You gotta help me, green. Let's work together on this bot. When the green player has such a big cap, us going against each other, I mean, dude. Ugh. It's painful, man. It is painful. I may just have to deal with the bot since green doesn't want to. And then try to work in the card block on the same turn. I think what I'll do is the next time that the bot does not have a set on five, I just do it. And then I just try to work in a card block. And then I just let it implode where it may. Yep. But yeah, guys, some other changes that are going to be coming here soon. Actually, do I just do it this turn? It would be 400. The bot would have 5. The bot would have 4. Oh, do I do it this turn? Is it worth it? The bot's got over 1,000 troops now. I would put it on my big stack and go around. I don't think so. I think green just wins that engagement because green has... Well, green is... I would open you up here, pop, drop troops right here. Because green's in Istanbul and Kharkiv. So I drop take here. Maybe I'd have to go through. No, it would be too messy. I don't think it's time just yet. This end game is crazy, guys. These blizzards are insane. These blizzards are insane. If I win this game, I definitely throw it up on YouTube. Yeah, and then green's just taking a card and passing, guys. I don't know. What would you do here? You know? The bot's got like 1,000 troops on the east side of Europe. And green does not want to help. And instead, green, whenever they set, they choose to go into me specifically. Just a question? What's up, Pete? Let's hear it, man. I'm ready. Do I set just yet? I missed that. That's why you were saying that. Hi, Robo. I'm curious. Are you half Asian? I am not. I've got that before. Whenever I met my wife, for those of you guys who don't know, she is half Mexican and half Salvadorian. She asked about my ethnicity when we were dating, and because she thought that I might have been Hispanic or, you know, maybe I had some Asian in there. No, I did my 23andMe, or no, I did Ancestry.com. And I am Scandinavian, so I have Swedish in me, I have Norway in me, and then I have a lot of English in me from the UK, and then a small amount of Native American, and that's about it. So yeah, no Asian in me, like 0%, actually. But it's just my, what are they called? It's like a combination of hooded eyes or something, and then almond-shaped eyes. I got that gene, so... Yeah, but maybe I could see it though, man. Yeah, I could see it. I could see why people think that or would ask for sure. I could see Hispanic too. Yeah, I'm kind of a hard one to guess. But no, I'm 100% white. I'm just a bunch of different flavors of white, but mostly Scandinavian, mostly. Yep. I had like what was it? I had like 5% German, and then a bunch of Swedish and a bunch of English. And then like a little bit of Norway and stuff. What about you, Pete? You said you did the 23andMe. What were you? If I had to guess what Pete is, dude, let me think about that. Pete's probably... I mean, you can't tell from like the lighting, but Pete and I actually have like similar like hair color and stuff. And a little bit similar features. Yeah, Pete, I could see Swedish for Pete. I could see English. I could see German. You know, Pete, I wouldn't be surprised if he's just like, no, I'm like 30% Russian. He just gives us a wild card or something. All right, so we set. Gosh. Bot's on 3 cards. I think I'm going to go ahead and kill the bot on the following turn, maybe. Take a card up here. Put the rest on my big stack. And since green does not want to help, I will be forced to kill the bot, I think. Next time the bot's on 4 cards, I believe that the percentage chance that somebody has a set on 4 is about 75% to 80%. So I don't think it's the correct play to wait until the bot has 5 cards. And then I have to try to figure out a way to work in the card block on green, considering they're going to have more troops than me by about 1,000. Green will have more. But I can't. Oh, this sucks, guys. Sucks. Let's see. You guess first, then I'll tell you. Yeah, pretty bad yesterday. Pete is 50% psycho, 50% everything else. Yes, the Piedmont is crazy. Let's see. Do you have any Irish in you? My mom is Dutch. She met my dad over there and moved. My father is a Jewish guy that looks like Eugene Levy. Interesting. Very interesting. The bot's trying to card block you? Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, I can't set. I think I want to... Oh, dude, God, this sucks. I'm just going to do it, guys. Whatever, man. I'm just going to do it. And then let's go out. Actually, you know what? I'm going to actually bring my 100 up. So, well, whatever. Oh, I'm playing this so sloppy right now, dude. I'm playing like, oh my god, and the board's flying all over the place. What is happening, folks? Am I gonna have to... I'd have to open up... Oh, I'm playing like such an imbecile. Tiny Brain Robo has arrived. See, you guys, that's the difference maker that you get on my channel. You learn how to play like a grandmaster and a novice at the same time. Something unique that I offer, just throwing it out there. Let's see. Just joined my first game today and got an immediate disconnect. Never trying to climb the ladder again. Get too angry, dude. Yeah, it's tough, man. We've been fortunate over here in my area to have, you know, very minimal issues. Okay, the bot sets and then it all goes on the right side of the board. Okay. That's nice. Yeah, no, it's tough. We've been very fortunate to not have too many issues with our internet, but I totally feel that, man. I get into so many games where people disconnect when they're in like a good position. It doesn't make any sense, and it's just, you know, internet, right? 2 yesterday, 18 with this disconnect, probably 30. Oh, man, that's tough. That is tough. Okay, so having that one up there is doing nothing for me. Let's go ahead and just close that off. And then I think what I want to do... Oh, we're playing so bad right now, guys. How do I make this work here? I think I'm just going to start working in a card block. Let's set. And then go pop, pop. Right here. Yeah. Okay. And then now we force green to have to take cards on the bot. I think that's what we do. Force green to take cards on the bot. Green is not interested in opening me up, so it is what it is. Gizzy Charger, thank you so much for the subscription, man. Okay, do you smack my 500? Go ahead. Okay, nice. I'm gonna say well played. See you in the... Okay, whatever, dude. Green player's coming out now. The green player just refusing to work with me on the bot. Just refusing. Ooh, you lose 1,000! Oh my god! Oh, GG! Good game! Oh my god! Oh! Oh my god! Oh my goodness, dude. It's like the Risk gods came out of nowhere. Oh my god, what is that? Is that the Risk gods?
Yes, my child.
Was that you who just gifted us with the blessed roll from the green player?
Yes, my child.
Oh my goodness, thank you. I could have used that a little bit earlier, but it...
Do not disrespect me.
Okay, my bad. I won't disrespect you anymore. Okay, and then they just left. Okay, sorry. So I pissed off the Risk Gods. Not my best play, gonna be honest with you guys. They're not the ones to piss off, but it is what it is. We should be able to get the W here. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay, the Risk Gods pop in. Look, they gift us that. I kind of fucked up by saying that they should have given us that a little bit earlier, and then now they're pissed off, and so we'll see. Well, there goes your dice rolls now. Yeah, I think my dice rolls are probably chalked now. That is my bad. Yeah. Okie dokie, folks. Look, I believe we got the cap run right here, right? Pretty sure. I'm pretty sure we got the cap run now, folks. So let's go ahead. What? You have a 700. That's more important considering where the bot's at. You can try to roll one of my caps, but then I just immediately retaliate with the other, whichever one you choose to roll. And the bot steps off and then I win. Oh my god. Okay, yeah, well played. Dude, you know what? I'm actually so glad that I can give the green player third place because the green player burned their bridges with me. Like an absolute baby. I was trying to... Okay, but I'll throw Robo-Love out there to the green player. But the green player was such a baby. I wanted to kill white, and then they just kept going into me. So now you get third place. Let that be a lesson to you. Oh my god, I was joking when I said give the bot second, lol. Well, hey, dude, it's gonna happen. The green player should not have turned their back on me. Now, realistically, though, it's just... that's the right play, right? If I want to end the game, the bot is still so strong. They have like 2,000 troops over here. The bot's actually got more troops than me now. Oh, yeah, and then now that they have 500 there, dude, are you just gonna... I need you to step off this cap. I need you. I need you to step off. Killing green would set me, so it's the right play. But dude, the green player literally gave me the most shady energy in this three-player endgame. Step off? Let's go. GG. Okay, I roll that now for sure. Oh, you're gonna force me to push through a bunch of troops, though. Oh my god, the bot just... Wait, that's the best karma ever. That's the best karma I could have asked for. Oh my god. Wait, hold on. Is Pete still... LOL gives himself third. Oops. Wait, hold on. Is Pete still here? I didn't... Okay, so Pete is Dutch and Jewish. Gotcha. Dutch and Jewish. I never got a conclusion on that. That's pretty cool. Okay, folks. You have a 1,000. Jeez. Let's see if I can get it. It's going to be really tight. I got to go through a 69. Oh, baby, we get it done, ladies and gentlemen. That is a GG. And if you're watching this on YouTube, thank you so much for watching. Shout out to everybody in the chat. We're going to have these live streams going up every Saturday on both Twitch and YouTube. And also, check out the YouTube Shorts. Thank you guys so much again for watching. It looks like Ahmed wants to be friends. Yes, we can be friends. We will be best friends. But the Blackberry Bonkers wearing a bucket gets the dub. Thank you guys so much again for watching, and I will see you guys on the next one.